Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome back to another week. Now, as you can see, we once again have our fill-in. Thanks for joining us, new guy.
Hello.
But you also notice that Gareth isn't here. And normally, if two of my players canceled, I would cancel. But I don't know if I'm going to be able to stream next week. So we're going. We're here. And Baron already froze. So it is a quintessential dire roll stream. We already got Vaclo frozen. We're missing players. It's time to role play. So once again, since Wisely isn't here, and even when she gets here, I'm gonna have to at least wait 1 week for her to catch up, because she's not gonna be able to do a recap of a week she wasn't here. I guess I have to do the recap, and I hope Vaclo's memory is good, because I don't think he's hearing us right now. I definitely think he's frozen. Oh, which means our frames are probably going to get screwy here in a bit when he restarts his computer. It's funny, though. The only guy among us who works in, like, a computer field has the most computer issues.
Right? I'm on a Mac, you know?
Oof.
It should be me.
Yeah.
You're looking for trouble.
You're on a Mac, which means you're on a laptop.
Yes.
No, I mean, even their desktops are like laptops. In college,
no,
I had a desktop.
I'm on a laptop. Yeah.
Right, right. But in college, I had a desktop Mac, and I melted the graphics card. Yep, there go the frames. I melted the graphics card playing a video game.
Just one.
Yeah, just one.
My computer has a really hard time with, like, Civ 5.
Ouch.
Yeah, so, but it's also from 2013, 2012.
Were you even alive back then?
Oddly enough, yes. I'm actually secretly 300-something years old.
Oh, well.
But now this entire stream knows.
So we all have to die. All right.
Yeah.
Well, we better make it a good stream then. Welcome back, Vaclo. You missed it. We're all doomed. Actually, no, since you missed it, you probably get to live.
Yeah, you're alive.
Tell our story. All right, so the recap. Last week, Mouse has come down with the sewer plague. It's treatable. And you guys went into the village and found their cunning man, who, much to your surprise, was actually a lizard folk by the name of Now. And Now has kind of joined you guys. He's looking after Mouse, as well as he knows how to fight, so he's been traveling alongside you. And we were going to write him off the show, but then we had a bunch of absences, so he's back.
Hello.
Welcome back.
Just write him out.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, he served his purpose. No, he's back. we're glad he's back. I like having a new guy around. I just don't tell him to his face, and now the cat's out of the bag. This is the stream of truths, it seems.
Yeah. You have a title for this episode.
Ones. Stream of Truths. Yeah, I might call it that. Yeah. So, we're going to be... So, from that village, you guys went to the town of Stellberg. I get the Stells confused, and I named them. I think it was Stellberg.
Stellberg, and then Hornbluff.
You guys kind of painted the town red with your fellow Grey Banner adventurers from the group known as the Vagabonds. However, you had a sobering experience when orcs attacked the town proper, and they seemed to have been assisted by elves who blocked your passage to the ferry in order to go confront the orcs. One of the elves, a particularly large and scary-looking, well-armored, well-armed elf, provoked Vaclo, and took him out in one turn. Yeah.
I did attack first.
It's true. However, because it's 5th edition, he's fine. He bounced back. He's either dead or A-OK in this game system. And then you guys journeyed along the South Road, where you met a drunk man. Well, actually, he wasn't drunk at the time. A drunk-erd.
Hangover minstrel.
Named Iflar the Troubadour, and he is a traveling minstrel, and you guys took him with you down to Hornbluff. And he said that he looks forward to the next time you guys cross paths. And then you guys went on your separate ways. And you chartered a ship. And you've taken the caravan. Your exploration team has finally found what they hope to be the entrance to the Wet City, which is the lost dwarven city, which is the purpose of all your hardships up to this point. No. Apparently my toddler's watching. That's okay. He's already swore quite a bit in the last week. So I'm sure whatever he hears here will be fine.
I'm usually PG-13.
Yeah, I try not to swear, and I doubt he can read, so I think
that's true. There you go. If you need to cuss, type it. There you go. What else? Oh, yeah. Inside the entrance to the Wet City, which is kind of like this overhanging cave, you're looking for some kind of mineshaft entrance that'll lead you into the city proper. Unfortunately, so far what you've discovered is a lot of very dangerous squatters. You encounter this strange arachnid humanoid creature who you dispatched, and then you fought a strange troll, and then you ran afoul of a kind of family of troglodytes, where you teamed up with your mercenary buddies, Carl, Hoff, Yuri, and of course Priska, and you guys defeated the troglodytes. However, two of the four mercenaries were beaten into unconsciousness by the troglodytes, and where we last left off, Now had just taken the mercenaries back to base camp, which you had set up at the mouth of this cave, to treat them. And, leaving the three of you behind in the cave structure. The three of you being Garrus, Vaclo, and Caddy. And, unfortunately, Mouse, I was really struggling. Wisely, if you're watching this, I'm sorry. Mouse is still down with the sewer plague, so that's where we're gonna begin. Did I not turn off the music? I know you guys can't hear, but I can. Yeah, I forgot to hit pause on that.
Nice. Did we not go rest after the kind of firefight?
There has not been a rest. We ended rather abruptly because the fight took a while.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. That's that.
No! I hate when things open on the wrong monitor. Drives me crazy. Okay, so I take it you guys want to start tonight off resting. What an energized beginning.
Yes, I just, you know, it's useful to have spell slots.
Baron, blink twice if you're still here. Oof. All right, we're going to have a hard time tonight. So, it's just going to be... Caddy, you're the only regular left, it seems. No, Baron will
make all the decisions.
Yeah, Baron will come in and out, I'm sure.
I'm sure.
So, yeah,
well,
you guys are going to
do
a rest?
Rest.
Yeah.
Yes, I want spell slots.
So you want a long rest?
Oh, yeah. It's probably not the best idea then. I just only have one left. I'm max HP, so other than that, I'm fine. So I don't really need to rest unless we're getting spell slots. But I don't. We can see what Baron wants to do. Now that he's kind of.
Vaclo,
you kind of returned.
I disconnected my webcam because this is ridiculous. Sorry about that.
All right, I'd rather have you and not be able to see you than not have you every 10 minutes.
Yeah, I'm going to have to apply the same hotfix I had last time, which only solved part of the problem. I thought I was out of it. I'm pissed.
All right, well, compartmentalize, because it's time to be happy.
Yeah, I am. That's it.
All right, Caddy is proposing a long rest.
Or none at all.
Well, the Nell says that he could use a very short rest.
Okay.
I could use a long rest also. I mean, I'm pretty banged up.
Okay. So you guys retire back to base camp. I mean, you guys have discovered that the area is rather inhospitable, so it behooves you to rest up and come at it fresh in the next day. So everybody get back to fighting form.
It's been a while since I played a spellcaster. Do we get all spell slots back after a long run? Mm-hmm.
Good. And half rounded up any hit dice you spent. No, not spent. Your total hit dice. Up to how much you spent.
Okay, well, before I rest, I'm going to use at least one.
You will be full HP after a long rest, so...
Oh, true. Never mind. Temporary HP gone, max HP, everything's good, spells are back. I think I'm ready.
I'm good, I just had to do my spells.
Thanks, Gold Public. I appreciate your attempted raid. Welcome.
Attempted raid.
That's what they called it, so, you know. Appreciate it nonetheless.
It's very nice, still.
Yep. Man, you guys can be so incredibly still sometimes with Vaclo constantly crashing. I'm like, oh no, everyone's frozen.
I'm contemplative.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so having rested, you guys are going to head back in?
Oh, yeah.
All right, in the morning, or more like around noon, the mercenaries are feeling much better under the tender, loving care of our lizard folk man. However, they decide that since the area, these tunnels you're immediately at, appear to be filled with dangerous creatures, they've decided that the mercenaries will guard base camp and you guys will continue exploring.
That's smart. We have an ill person that needs guarding. And also a useless academic.
Wait, wouldn't that be one and the same?
That's
what, useless and academic? Yes. It's a redundant name.
It's redundant. Alright, so, do you guys want to head back to the room that you killed all the troglodytes in?
Yep. So I'm guessing, since we took the right branch, the left branch eventually led to the same room, right?
Yeah, eventually they've led to the same kind of ruins. However, you're not sure, like, yeah. At some point they met up, obviously, because you ran into the mercenaries.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so, yeah.
But the journey was different.
That's true. If you guys want to go in the other direction, you guys can see what you can see. Otherwise, yeah.
Oh, we would, yeah. Left sounds good. We want to explore.
Okay.
Yeah, let's
keep going. Before you leave, you guys all... Well, actually, let's go ahead and let's have you guys roll. Everyone make a perception check. I'm hoping we'll have art soon. I have commissioned art for all the main player characters. Not you, new guy, sorry.
Hey, now, same role.
Yes.
So that's a 13-13 and a 14. Okay, that's good enough. You all notice, just before you leave, Gareth is rummaging around in his alchemist kit, and he pulls out this small vial of kind of translucent green liquid, and he downs it. And when he does... He kind of looks around, almost confused, and then he just kind of starts following you guys, but you can all tell he's acting a little strangely.
What does he say as if Vaclo tells him, like, snap out of it, man. We need you focused.
He looks at you kind of sideways and just says, we'll be all right. Just,
right.
I don't know. Did we have anything to drink last night?
I haven't.
My memory's a little foggy, but I'm sure it'll pass.
I don't know about you, but we didn't have anything to drink last night. Is that what's in your vials?
Vials? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you're always mixing stuff. Is it alcohol?
Not today.
Liquid fire? Wait, that's a thing, ain't it? Well, you know.
Don't worry about it, I'll be fine. I'm sure it'll all come back to me.
Sounds good to me. And Vaclo proceeds.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't care. Also, I'm riding a skew, so we know he's there.
Lest we forget.
Well, he wasn't on as a token last time, so.
Right, I just, for sake of ease of you moving around the board, I just say you're either riding him or he's beside you. Unless you want to separate him from you in combat, then I'll put his token down.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I figured. I just like to clarify.
Okay, I'm going
to
put you guys on the map. But until you guys get into something interesting, we'll just keep it to you guys. Are you guys good with that marching order? If not, you can swiggle around.
I can't see it yet.
So. What?
There we go.
Okay.
So it was loading. Yeah, that's fine. I got a feeling now is beefier than I am.
All right.
When we're in the 5-foot corridor, Vacto would be in front, of course.
So, once you guys progress some, you come to a T-junction. I mean, a crossroads. There are two narrow kind of archways on either side of you, and then the larger hallway that you've entered continues southward. You guys can probably see the end.
Do a survival check to see if I can spot any sorts of activity and what kind?
Sure. 15. You see some boot prints in the available dirt. The air, this whole kind of ruin is very damp. Probably gets a lot of that from the ocean that is exposed to. So there's quite a few muddy boot prints. However, after careful examination, you determine that these boot prints more than likely belong to your mercenaries when they came through here last, and they are about a day old. Well, actually more like 12 hours old.
All right. Yeah.
The Knoll Room, first of all, it was troglodytes. And second of all, you went the other way, so you're not sure in relation to where the troglodytes were.
So yeah, the first time we went right and the others went left. Nobody went straight ahead.
I think there are only two paths.
There were two paths. You're on the second path now. You're going the way the mercenaries went.
Okay. I'm situated now.
Okay, cool.
So yeah, we'll take a quick peek at the room on my right.
Stage right, or?
Stage right, not mine yet. The Vaclo's direction right now.
So okay.
Here.
Oh, okay. That would not be stage right. Okay, that room it's obviously has this caved-in section, and there used to be some standing pillars that have been knocked down, and you also see some still water that has kind of taken up occupancy in this room.
And I probably can hear nothing special.
Mm-mm. However, you do note that it looks unfamiliar, whereas behind you in the other direction, you see a standing pillar in the center of a room. And you can vaguely remember from yesterday's travels that this is the large kind of atrium adjacent to where you fought the arachnid creature.
Mm-hmm.
So you're like right next to... You're in the hallway adjacent to that kind of encounter.
Gotcha. So Vaclo's going to propose this room is unknown. We should check it.
I feel like...
He's going to investigate the door frame to see if there's a trap or anything, and then he's going to enter the room.
I feel like if we're going to find a way into the hidden city, it's going to be kind of involved with the larger machinations of this kind of area, not so much the smaller rooms.
I want to make sure we don't miss anything.
All right, that's fair. Let's do it.
Okay.
Vaclo,
you don't see any signs of traps. However, does anyone read, speak, what have you? Is anyone proficient in Dwarven?
Let
me check.
Yeah. I need to make sure I have Gareth's sheet.
I should know that. No.
Dwarven and Orcish.
Okay. You see some very eroded, faded runes in Dwarven that are marking this room. You can't make up much. But you do make out the word mine, M-I-N-E, although, you know, in whatever spelling that would be an actual Eastman, but for us English speakers.
Mm-hmm. So, in Dwarven, is mine the possessive thing or the mine, like, the cavern? I'm just kidding. Are they the same word?
Yeah, I'm sure they're not. So this would be the noun.
All right. Oh yeah, no.
It belongs to someone.
Yeah, I was about to make that same joke.
Yeah, the full sentence was, "Don't enter here, it's mine." But, you know.
Yeah.
Dwarven is such a weird language.
Alright, so I'm gonna enter the room.
Anything now you want to go ahead of me?
Up to you.
Alright, fine.
I think I'm going to go ahead and throw up the map for the viewers now.
I would specify I have a torch lit in my shield hand.
Okay.
And I'm going to look at the walls to see if there's any other rooms.
Hey, Vaclo, check this out.
Hmm. I go check it out. Ooh.
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 More tunnels.
I'm a stealthily stealth in that direction.
I have to
for
move
a second.
Gareth. Ooh, that's gonna be frustrating. Go ahead and make a perception check real quick.
Alright.
Okay, well, toddler's on the loose. Yeah, it looks like a muddy tunnel.
I don't see nothing. But can I investigate before I walk in here to see if I see any traps?
Can't fit. Come here.
He wants to say hi. Oh, the cruelty.
One second.
Do not look behind the curtain.
I'm sorry, could you repeat that?
Which part? The pay no mind to the man behind the curtain?
No, the pertinent
or...
part.
I rolled investigation to see if I saw any traps when
you
I...
You did indeed.
Oh, nice.
You don't see any traps. However, investigation shows that... This area used to be much wider, but it appears a mudslide, like a very muddy collapse cave-in, has filled this area with mud and padded the wall, packed the walls with what basically has become clay. But you suspect, with this very high investigation roll, that this area was once a large ravine, possibly a mine shaft, but it has since been filled in.
And I wanna note that I'm doing this stealthily, so I'm gonna stealth roll that just as I walk this way, just in case that becomes pertinent.
Okay.
Oh, nice. Askew and I are real quiet.
Since Vaclo can see that she stealths, he's gonna stay put and stop moving.
Okay.
This is odd. Where's Gareth when we need him? Do I need to make a new investigation roll every time I kind of come into an area?
Yes. However, as you're passing through this hallway, you kind of feel the ground shake. The pebbles on the muddy ground kind of like jitter around, bounce around haphazardly.
Ooh.
Run!
Can we hear that?
Yeah, everyone kind of hears this low grumble.
Ooh, okay, I'm gonna advance 10 foot in case she needs my help. Like, I'm gonna brace myself on the wall and in case the ground gives out under her feet.
The low grumble doesn't sound like any particular beast.
Make a nature check.
Can I do two?
Yeah, you both can.
Nice, because we both heard it.
Hey, Simon, now that you're here, can you do a shout out for my maps and tokens? I'll put you to work. Nothing. I mean, there are a lot of burrowing creatures.
That growl?
It's not. It wasn't a growl. That was just the ground kind of going, kind of churning.
Oh, okay.
But You're not... I mean, it's kind of hard to tell just from the ground shaking. You could think of a number of subterranean creatures. This could be one of them, or it could just simply be... Although, from the pattern, it kind of feels like this is more like a natural movement. This isn't like something slithering under or around you.
All right. And then I made that investigation when I walked in, but it's not a very good one.
Well, being wise, now I was going to say, if this thing was a cave-in, it's possible that this is another cave-in. I'd be careful.
Okay, I'm going to... Y'all, there's a light this way, so I'm going to go check it out.
And as soon as you say that, everyone stop. The ground right here doesn't so much open as it kind of just melds into a creature.
Oh,
a
no.
A creature with arms and legs, and it appears to be made of magically awakened mud.
Maybe it's friendly.
Friends, there's some... It doesn't look friendly, Caddy.
It raises its muddy fist to smash poor Vaclo, and we roll initiative.
It's not friendly.
That's really good.
Well, you guys are going before it.
Nice.
The one time a creep rolls 2, we all roll like 15 plus.
Yeah, I usually roll 4, 5s, 6s.
Alright, Vakla, you're first. And yeah, Gold, I really love Gabriel's maps. They're amazing. And the token artist is the only one putting out really good fantasy tokens, in my opinion, on the marketplace right at this point. I almost commissioned him to do our artwork, but I found a better price locally, so I took it. But yeah, I like both of these. That's why I wanted to use them, and I appreciate them allowing me to stream them. So go ahead, Vaclo.
Yeah, all right. So I get my sword out of this scabbard. I'm going to trip attack it.
Oh, good luck.
That's not going to hit.
It's also
That bounces off of its muddy, kind of craggy body. You just hit one of its mud pecs. Sort of just flex.
It's too muddy. But I'm still going to try and attack it once more with Action Surge.
Ooh, right out of the gate with Action Surge.
Short rest. It's too muddy.
It's too muddy.
Vaclo is frustrated and he's going to head this turn.
All right. Now. It is now your turn.
Yes.
That's never going to get old.
Nope, it's not.
It's old now.
GG.
You're okay. Just saying that because I used IM instead of DM.
Yes.
Does this... Okay, it's not an AoE, so that's good. So I can actually attack it without attacking... Vaclo, so I'm going to extend my hand out toward a creature and cast a poison spray, but I need to be 10 feet away from it, so I'm going to move one step ahead. Then I'm 10 feet away from it, and I can do it. And it's a one action, no concentration, cantrip. Ooh, I couldn't have rolled lower.
Con, huh? Alright, he has a +5. Am I muted? I feel muted. I'm not muted. He has +5 con.
You're okay.
He did not save.
But hold on. I forgot to put wisdom mod on the damage. I'm assuming it does get the wisdom.
No, not generally.
Okay, maybe not. I'm going to double check. But
most spells
require
some kind of class option to get a modifier to your damage, including cantrips.
Yeah, it's the two hit that get the wisdom. I forgot. Yeah, so 3.
Okay, so as your poison splashes up against this mud creature, it appears completely unfazed by poison, and you have determined that this creature is immune to poison damage.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
It's too muddy.
Is that you?
I told ya.
Well, I don't have any other actions, so that's pretty much it. I could move back, but for now I'm fine.
All right. Well, I'm going to go ahead and aim for its little muddy golem face. I feel bad about it, though. I'm going to shoot my longbow.
Yeah.
14 to hit.
Yeah, that your arrow ricochets off of it.
Yeah, when the DM says good luck when Vaklo is about to attack, it's not a good sign.
Well, you tried to do a trip attack when he's standing on the material he's made out of, so I kind of figured that was why.
Yep, true. Vaklo wants to trip everything. That's his fighting style.
All right, well, that's my turn.
Don't wear it out. All right, Gareth, you're up. Thank you, Jaken. You are a great DM. It's nice of you to say, Gareth.
Sounded worse than Siri.
Alright. I had to remember that he's an archer. I was about to have him run up. So he's gonna fire his bow.
He's an archer if he's involved in combat directly.
What are you implying?
Well, because otherwise he's indirectly involved with combat by, like, sneaking up behind people.
You know what I just realized? When Gareth made his character, he put shortbow under melee weapons. I don't think that changes anything. I'm just going to hit go. Thank God he's here, right?
Oh,
so he
thanks,
crit.
Gareth. You're so brave and capable.
And he gets his sneak attack damage, which is doubled because he crit, so that's 2d6. Nice.
Man,
so you did a total of
20,
18
max,
damage.
Min, max, min. You are the craziest DM on rolls I've ever seen.
Sucks to be you then, I guess. Yeah, so that arrow kind of took some chunks out of it. Some muddy, kind of clay-like bits fly out of it, the wound. Didn't seem to harm it much. Harmed it nonetheless.
Hmm. So
furious typing.
Yeah, sorry. Nice. So it can be hit.
Yep. All right. Now the mud creature's turn. It raises two big fists, dripping with clay and mud in the air. Brings one down on Vaklo. It has a +8 to hit. Vaklo moves out of the way. And then, without lifting its arm, it brings the other one down now where Vaklo is. And again, Vaklo, using his shield, kind of like hits it and then brushes himself to the side of it and evades both huge, meaty clay fists from smashing his delicate face. And now
Vaklo probably was still trying to trip it, like hitting its leg. And it's my turn, so yeah. I'm gonna try another trip attack. That's more like it.
That is going to be a hit.
So that's 19 damage and strength save DC 13.
Alright, again, you take some bits out of it, not as much as you were expecting with that blow, and then it needs to make a strength 13. It has +5 strength, so anything higher, an 8 or higher will succeed. Wow, okay. You knock this guy prone. You separate him from the rest of the mud, and he falls on his back analog.
That makes no sense.
It does make sense. He swept the leg.
But there's... it's weird.
Vaklo, Cobra Kai.
Cobra Kai. I'm going to use my Shieldmaster feat as a bonus action to uselessly shove it. And that's going to be my turn since I don't have any more action surges, and everybody else is going to have advantage on him.
Actually, it's only advantage on melee. I think you may have screwed your archers.
That's right. Sorry. I'm done. I'm going to move here, and I'm done.
Okay.
So poison does nothing to it. Hitting it with melee seems to do a little bit of something, but not too much.
What's the word?
Bird?
Shillelagh!
Oh.
Yeah, no, Shillelagh is the next thing I'm gonna try, but first I'm just gonna try like think about my other spells. So I could do Thunder. Thunder against Mud doesn't look very much like this. What about this one? Does it do damage? It does damage. I'm assuming it's just magic damage.
The mental Jeopardy music is playing. Will I get copyright struck on YouTube if we start humming it? Is that public?
I mean,
is that public sphere?
You could claim it's protected under parody.
YouTube doesn't care about that. Also, I don't monetize my VODs, so I guess it doesn't really matter.
So I cast Shillelagh.
Okay.
I move up, and I hit him with Shillelagh.
Quick question before you roll.
Yes.
I doubt it, because it's a cantrip, but does Shillelagh turn into magic damage, perchance?
Yes.
It does?
Oh, yeah. That's the only use.
Druid's OP. All right, go ahead. Ah!
A crit?
Yep. Yeah, you come up to it, and you give it a fierce twapping. Also, you had advantage on that, but you crit anyway, so what difference does it make, right?
Yep.
Yeah, you gave him a fierce wallop. Bits and chunks fly off of his knee. He used to be a mud monster, and now he's just a lonely guard. Is that all from now?
Well, I don't have anything else but my reaction, so yes.
Caddy.
All right, that's...
Now,
looking good.
I believe you have disadvantage to shoot him since he's prone.
Yeah.
So this may be a time to unleash the boar.
Yeah. I'm just gonna tell Askew to go get him. Do I need a token for that, or can we just assume? There you go.
It's not much to do it.
I was
so
sure.
so pro DM.
Oh gosh, where's his rolls? Okay, and then that doesn't count as a charge because he didn't move very far or quickly in the straight line.
Unfortunately, he comes up and... Oh wait, you had advantage. Go ahead and
roll again.
Yep. We'll take the first damage, so... Okay, well, it wasn't any better. Yeah, doesn't get through the muddy carapace.
Yeah.
Wow, don't jinx it, Baron. Come on now. Alright, Gareth's turn. Gareth has melee weapons, yes. He's going to switch weapons and step forward so that he has that advantage. And then he's going to rapier. And he hit. Plus an additional sneak attack damage. Nice. He took a little bit out of this guy. Just for fun, let's have him offhand a dagger. He hit for a little bit of damage. Okay. Its turn. It comes to stand. It's now mad at two of you. So first it's going to try to wallop old Vaclo. But Vaclo's too...
Miss again.
Yeah,
you're
just
slippery.
Bobbing and weaving. Don't have flat feet. That's the secret here. However, we shall now see...
That's the reason.
However, let's see if now has the same luck. Five or up is going to be a hit with a plus +8. That's a hit. Oof. Take 13 bludgeoning damage.
Was that Vaclo?
No, that was now.
That was me.
Oh.
I took a whole lot of damage.
You need to learn to dodge, friend.
Yeah, so this big clay fist kind of slams into Now's shoulder, almost bringing him completely to the ground. You guys all hear this audible kind of crunch as he's probably dislocated that shoulder. And, Vaclo, you're up.
Alright, leave my friend alone. I'm gonna attack it with my weapon. Normal attack this time.
Yeah, he probably would have dodged that if he was underwater. Oof, you just barely kind of glance across his clay body and just leave a line of kind of superficial.
Alright. I'm gonna use my bonus actions to try and make it prone again with my shield, Master Thingy.
That's opposed, right?
Yeah.
Alright, he has a plus 5. He remains standing. All done?
Yep, I'm done.
Now it is now.
Well, kind of need to get away from him, but if I do, attack of opportunity, so I'm kind of stuck here. Could do Thunder Wave, could do Entangle, could do Cure Wound. Is there anything that is only a bonus action anywhere? No, because that would be way too OP. Well, I guess it's gonna be a twap with the shillelagh. That's pretty much what I can do. Or I could cure wound myself.
Yeah, you don't look very good.
I'm gonna cure wound myself just to be safe. If he hits me again, I'm in trouble. So, cure wound myself. Well, not too bad.
And then you're done?
Sorry?
Are you done?
Yeah, I can't do anything Caddy, aside from moving
you
away,
up?
But I'm not doing that.
Alright, I'm gonna cheer askew on again to really get him. That's not gonna do it.
Askew is giving it the old college try for a boar.
That mud's just so sticky. Getting real caught up in it.
Tell me about it.
You done?
Yeah.
Alright, Gareth is going to disengage as a bonus action, using his cunning action. And then he's going to let loose some shooty-shooty.
One more crit.
And like Vaclo, his arrow kind of like superficially leaves a line across the solidifying clay. This creature is becoming less mud and more clay as he exists in y'all's space. Then it's his turn, the big creature. And once again, he's going to try to clobber Vaclo. Just barely. Once again, you use your shield to kind of obstruct his path. And however, he is once again going to come down on now. And he's going to once again hit.
That's not good.
For the exact same damage. With the exact same dice rolls. At least he's consistent. That's 13 bludgeoning. So after healing that shoulder, it gets cracked again in the same spot. Now you're sure it's dislocated. Vaclo, you're up.
He's consistent, but the more we hit him, the less he is. So I'm gonna try to hit him again. I think... Actually... I'm gonna ask the druid to hit him once more with his shillelagh. So instead of me attacking, you attack and you would get bonus damage if you hit, and it's sad since I've rolled very well. you do magic damage, that's my thinking.
And if he hits, he adds 4 to the damage?
Exactly, so you can attack right now.
I can attack now.
You can attack the creature now.
Is it with advantage or normal? It's normal, right?
Just normal.
Sorry.
Yeah, no problem. It's a risk I have to take. Seems like it would. I'm gonna try again bashing it with my shield. As a bonus action, and after that I'm done.
He's prone.
Nice.
Probably should have done that first. Although, do you have to take an action?
I have to attack first.
You have to attack first?
That's what most people say on the forums, so that's what my other DMs ruled also. I never asked you, quite honestly.
I think that's how the wording is, but since you have to attack first, does using Commander Strike... Oh, it is the attack action. Okay, cool. I'll allow it.
Yeah.
He's prone. Okay. Now, all you're right.
Well, he's prone. I forgot the prone status. Does it allow him to attack? Yes, it does, right? But with disadvantage, if I'm not mistaken.
Who? What?
The Mud Golem.
Yeah, he has disadvantage on melee attacks outgoing from him. But
okay,
currently,
well,
you have advantage to wallop him.
Yeah, I'm going to try to twop him, and I'm going to try to move away and pray to God that he missed me.
Okay, so Shillelagh, boom, with advantage, boom.
It's a hit. You give him a fierce thwapping.
Yes, and then I'm gonna move out here, and I'm probably gonna get hit and fall down.
Okay, a five or higher hits you, so that is a miss.
Oh, yes. Nice.
You feel the air of the miss as you move away from it.
That was so risky.
Right. I know, right? But I had to do it.
Catty, you're up.
Oh, that was amazing.
So now if you spur your boar on, he'll have advantage.
Yeah. I couldn't see where our friend went now.
You saw me run toward the place where we came from?
Yeah, there's not a whole lot of options as far as where to go.
Yeah. I just wasn't sure how far now went. I am going to move a little bit. And then I'm going to spur askew on. But not literally, because that would be painful.
Advantage.
Hey, okay. His tusks find suitable purchase. Oh, nope. To give the guy a little bit of a scratchy. Whoa. Thanks for all the hosts, people. And it just keeps coming. Well, nice. Welcome everyone who just got here from the host. Man. I feel like this is the work of Simon. He's done some of his Simon trickery to get people
to watch.
Yeah,
somebody did something.
Welcome, everybody. We're playing 5th edition D&D. We're in the middle of a fight with a mud creature who's turning into clay as we speak, who keeps getting knocked prone, which is weird that he's not immune to that. All right, Gareth. Gareth is going to, once again, seeing that he is prone, he's going to rush forward, blades drawn, and give him the old smackadoodle. And his rapier finds a weak point where it's still clay to drive his blade through, and he's going to do his sneak attack damage. Oof. Doesn't really help. So he gets a little scratch in, and then he's going to strike with his offhand dagger. Once again, critting. All right. Mud Monster's turn. Mud Monster is going to come to a stand. As he stands, again, more and more of him, as he's kind of exposed to the oxygen air, is starting to, like, solidify into clay. He's kind of, like, half mud, half clay at this point. And he swings his fist down on Gareth, because Gareth has been sneaking in and getting those hits in. Gareth has 15 AC, so anything higher than a 6 will be a hit. That's a miss. And then once more, with his second fist, he's just going to keep putting the pressure on Vaclo. And Vaclo, you have a 10 or higher will hit. That is a hit. So Vaclo, you finally got slammed for 9 bludgeoning damage.
How come you get slammed and I get 13 twice?
Hey, I'm just tougher.
I don't remember making you the editor of the channel, but I guess it paid off. All right, Vaclo, you're up.
All right. I'm going to first... So did you say I could bash it first, though, right?
No, yeah, you gotta do it after the attack action.
Hey, guys, gotta try. So, 4 minimal damage, so barely a scratch. I think I'm gonna start massaging it. Might be more efficient, since it's...
Might mollify it, yeah.
And, I'm gonna try to make it prone again. By shield bashing it. Take that.
Yeah, you knock him prone again.
Nice. So
see, the bottom of his feet is turned clay, so now he's slipping around on the mud. That's what we're doing here.
Yeah, I'm
that
just
makes sense. That's logical.
That makes sense. Logical. Yeah. Well, thank you, Simon, for abusing your powers. I appreciate you, brother. Alright, you done?
Yep.
Alright, now you're up.
Okay, I need to be ranged at the point, because I'm not getting back into things. Do I have a ranged weapon? No, I don't. Do I have a ranged spell? We already said that the poison does nothing.
Do I have any boots that I can put on people? First, let's close all my spells because they're way too big.
New guy, come on, man. Think about your turn while it's everybody else's turn.
I know, but I was expecting to have something range, but I don't. How bad is it looking?
It's still looking pretty fit. You guys have, like, basically splattered mud all over the walls and scratched up his clay. He doesn't seem like he's slowing down anytime soon.
Is there an empty spot behind him?
No, not so much. Not really enough space. It would be a squeeze, which would give you disadvantage.
No, I'm not going. It's not me that's going there.
He cast a flaming spear.
Yeah, I'm gonna cast a flaming spear. Can it fit in there?
I think the rules as written say it can, as long as there's a par, but I'm not sure that's for 5e.
I'll allow it.
You'll allow it? Then, and I make it bounce into him.
Dex 13. Well, he's got a minus 1 dex, so he needs a 14 or higher. And there it is. He takes half, right?
Yes. Half of 8.
Actually, wait. He has disadvantage on dexterity saving throws whilst prone.
Funny crit.
You're trolling now.
I didn't... Alright, so when you strike it, a lot of the mud kind of like melts away, but what remains kind of quickly turns into clay. And I believe he's... Nope, not quite. Caddy, you're up.
Alright, I'm going to step back over here. Then I'm going to hand... This is the new one I picked up because I realized I was short one spell. So I'll send it out for you.
You sure?
What?
Is that the one you wanted?
Yeah, I'm just gonna hand 10 berries to now and be like, sit tight. That's it.
Gareth's turn.
That's silly, but okay, let's do this.
Alright, to the rapier, he's going to do a sneak attack damage. Cool. I rolled rapier twice. That was dumb. Oh, because I thought rapier was there. Alright, and then... there we go. And then his dagger gets in there for a little bit of damage. Alright, the mud creature is now wounded. Or damaged, however you want to interpret it.
Phew, I was starting to panic.
Its turn. It stands. And it's gonna 1-2 punch, starting with Gareth. Missing and then swinging at Vaclo. Hitting. For 14 bludgeoning damage. So you all see as Vaclo raises his shield and his entire body is just kind of engulfed in mud. And then, like, the arm kind of withdraws and Vaclo's still standing, but a little lower.
Yeah, I'm still on one knee at least, and I'm like, that's not good.
And Vaclo, it's your turn.
All right, I'm going to use a bonus action to catch my breath.
You damn creature, just die!
That's going to be...
Okay, real quick, I think...
Second wind?
My lighting is off, and I think I know why. Oof, that sucks.
It does. And then I'm going to try to kill it. I'm going to drop my longsword, pick my warhammer. I'm gonna attack it with the warhammer.
Is that better? I think it's better. I'm a little less blown out.
I think it might be better.
You hit. You done?
Yes, I'm done.
Alright. Now, you're up.
I believe it's a bonus action to make him bounce. Yes, it's to make it bounce back
That's
into him.
Worse. Once the sun goes down, I look great. Stupid sun.
Oh, well, 3 damage.
Oh, it's a flaming sphere. Got it. Okay, 3 damage it is. I did 32.
Uh,
and I'm going to use an action to eat a berry.
Oh, right. Because the Flaming Spear is a bonus. He's just like...
He's just eating blueberries. All
right, in addition to gaining one hit point, your breath is minty fresh. Caddy, you're up.
Yes.
Nice.
Then it's an efficient spell.
It's multi-purposed.
And at that, from... I can attack from kind of that diagonal place here, right?
Yeah, yeah. Diagonals count.
Nice. Let's hand axe that boy.
I don't think handing him an axe is going to help.
Well, that's why I didn't say hand hit that boy an axe. You're welcome.
You're welcome.
There we go.
Woohoo. I mean, yeah, you did some damage.
There we go.
Gareth is going to disengage. Whoop. And then shoot. Bonus action to disengage. His arrow does not penetrate its clay hide. It's turn. Once for Vaclo.
Yes.
And now it's going to take a swing at the little one, Caddy.
Mm.
Caddy.
Oh. Yes.
You evade.
Oddly enough.
Alright, Vaclo, you're up.
Okay, so we need to kill that thing.
Can I just say, he's got a +8 to hit. He should not have been missing as much as he has.
I know.
He really shouldn't have been missing me.
I mean, Vaclo's starting to think about retreat, but it's not really his style. So yeah, half. Choices. I'm just gonna wall up into it once more for 11 bludgeoning damage, and I'm gonna try to sweep it off its feet.
That's a pretty good attempt.
Mm-hmm. Ah.
He got a 22. He's prone.
Oh, I thought he had +8. Sorry.
Plus
good.
5. +8 to hit.
Mm-hmm. So that's my turn, and kill this thing.
Alright, now you're up.
Bounce the flaming spear into him, and then eat a berry again. That's pretty much going to be my turn until the end, so cast spell. 5. Really? Like 2d6? Is it 2d6 or 2d8 that I roll?
Yeah.
2d6, and I keep rolling like super shitty.
Well, we wouldn't want you guys to win. Alright, Caddy, you're up.
Alright, I'm gonna hit him with that hand axe again. Because it seemed to work last time.
And you have advantage, because he's prone.
Oh, nice.
Nice. A crit?
Yes. With those damage rolls, we need crits.
Alright, it's time to use Vaclo's favorite phrase. You guys are whittling him down.
Yay.
Gareth dives
like carving.
In. Sculpting. You're sculpting him down.
I was searching for the word.
Oof. No, you sculpt outward by adding material, you carve downward.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, you would know. I wouldn't. All right.
Since we're too old school.
He's going to use a sneak attack on his dagger because he didn't get to use it on his rapier for an additional 8 damage. So that's 13 damage. You're carving him down.
Yeah.
His turn. He stands up. He's none too pleased with you guys. He's gonna try to hit Vaclo again.
Ouch.
Ooh.
Oh, Vaclo falls down and he's out of it. He turns his head around and he asks about his mom.
Okay, and then he's going to try to hit Gareth. Oh, yeah, that's a hit. Ooh, Gareth takes 15 bludgeoning damage. Gareth, not looking great. He's wounded. Vaclo, death saving throw.
Hmm. Death, that's... let me find it again. I don't use
core
it a
page.
Lot.
Okay, that's one success. Now, you're up.
Mal's going to move here. Bonus action, bounce the sphere into that guy. Action, cure wounds on this guy. Let's do cure wounds first. And then let's do Flaming Sphere second.
Vaklo's gonna look at now, and for half a round he's gonna be like, Mommy, is that you?
Wow, your mommy must have been ugly.
Don't say that, I'm gonna find you.
Excuse you. Now as a very handsome lizard.
For the lizard kind, is actually pretty sexy. You got all the lady lizard.
he's got so many teeth.
Nice.
All right, now let's spend the next the rest of the session exploring the mating habits of lizard folk.
We're gonna have to. Take a trip down south.
Yes, that's all.
Catty, you're up.
All right, I'm gonna hunter's mark that boy.
Oh, now you are, huh?
Yeah, because Vaklo can't handle. I wasn't making any damage earlier. I wasn't making none. I wasn't hitting at all. Why was I going to use Hunter's Mark if I'm not hitting at all? Anyway, Vaklo's useless right now, so I might as well. Do I need to cast spell? Are you used to this one?
I'm good. I know it.
All right. And then I'm going to hit again.
Aside from Cure Wounds and Healing Word, I think Hunter's Mark is used the most. Especially, particularly if there's a range of the party.
And I chose Goodberry.
Yep.
We have healers. I'm funny.
I'm laughing.
I'm too.
That is a hit. You want to roll the extra damage?
Yeah, right. It's just...
1d6.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
Well, you got that damage in. All right.
Yeah, I think it's short of 5 damage. Probably.
Gareth is like, ow. He's going to disengage with his cunning action, move over here, and fire his short bow. He hits for 10 piercing damage. Alright, this thing is looking really rough. However, it is its turn. It is not aware that Vaklo is conscious at this point. So it turns fully towards the gnome.
At least the pig's
goodbye,
safe.
Gnome.
That's a miss.
It was fun knowing you, gnome.
That's a hit. You take 12 bludgeoning damage. It's a you dodge the first right into the second.
Ah, yeah.
And for a moment, Caddy disappears into a fist of mud and clay. And when it's emerged, all that's left is kind of like a perfect mud image of Caddy, just kind of frozen in place.
No, T-posing, holding the X. Perfect.
Right, you can tell how hard the mud guy has been hitting on Vaklo. He can't even spell his own name right in chat. Speaking of Vaklo, you're up.
Damn it. I'm gonna do what I do best. Try
to take over the world? I assume you're gonna stand up first?
Oh, yeah. Good call. And I miss.
You do, yeah.
I'm gonna knock it down.
It's a good roll. It's a good roll.
Mm-hmm.
Once again, you beat him by one.
Yes. At least I can do that. That's the end of my...
The history
my
books bird. Will remember the time that Vaklo knocked a mud creature off of mud like 6 times in one fight.
But you know what that means, Jake?
What?
He's going to try to knock down something ridiculously easy like a single goblin because you want to keep him alive, and he will fail like 7 times in a row.
That's never going to happen.
Oh, now, yeah, it's going to be like, Infinity War. Vaklo's gonna be Thanos and the goblin's gonna be Captain America?
Ah.
So, my turn. Tis. I'm assuming you can guess. It's gonna be Bounce and Goodberry.
Okay.
I can find... Oh, yeah, there you go. Flaming Sphere.
Is this...
Oh!
Here's when I succeed. Nope! If only you could crit.
Nice.
All right, with that 10 damage, this mud creature He's basically at death's door.
Okay, and I get one more good berry. That's my third one I eat. I'm keeping track.
Caddy.
Mm-hmm.
You're up.
I've got advantage to hit. I've got a hand axe covered in mud and ready for more. And add.
Unfortunately, the 11 was a miss, so.
Yeah.
Bit moot. Alright. Gareth.
Please, Gareth.
Gareth is injured. Even though he'd have advantage with his rapier, he's just gonna shoot, because. Actually, no, if he shoots, then he has disadvantage, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I gotta be true to Gareth here. If Gareth were this hurt.
He wouldn't go in.
He would
shoot with disadvantage.
He'd rather shoot with disadvantage. Yeah, his heart really wasn't in it. He
just
hit the
as
ceiling.
Long as he doesn't hit back.
Alright, big guy's turn. He stands up. And this kind of like churning, like grinding sound. It immediately tries to smash Vaclo.
You are not gonna
missing.
Succeed.
And then it swings its other fist kind of wildly down towards the gnome. Missing. Vaclo, you're up.
I'm too small.
That's so unlikely.
No, it's the camouflage he gave you. You look too much like the mud beneath him.
It's like this big.
I'm gonna roar and just bash into it. It's not gonna be effective very much, but I hope it's gonna do the job.
Yeah, so he's at death's door. Even more so. A gentle breeze
four.
Could kill this guy.
He's at one. He was at two. He's now at one. God.
Well, we'll see if Flaming Sphere does.
It's gonna.
Yeah, it's going to, no matter what.
Yeah.
Okay. So the Flaming Sphere plunges into his chest. And he kind of like writhes in pain, and then his entire body turns to clay. And he's now a statue.
Ah, Vaclo's gonna cheer and cough a little bit of blood.
I still have 6 good berry, which I hand to Vaclo.
Ah, yeah.
So he can just like scarf them down, and boom, you have 6 more.
There's this one.
He does.
Beam of sunlight coming through my blinds, right onto my head. And every time I look at my own image, it's driving me crazy. Because my head is already shiny enough. Thank you.
Are you sure it's not a sniper?
Are you guys getting vengeance for that time I talked about assassinating anyone who missed session?
And you told me so. So did the guy come through?
Well, welcome, poor son. I'm glad you've been trying to reach us.
Glad you could reach us.
Glad you made it. All right, that ends. That's gonna end combat.
Vaclo's gonna go back to the other non-muddy room right here.
As you guys, as you walk past Gareth, Gareth kind of follows you, and he's gonna say, "So we're not in the sewers anymore, are we?"
No, we're not. But I'm not sure it's better. And I'm gonna lie down and just rest.
Okay, Caddy. A skew comes up to your side.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna climb on because I don't feel so hot.
Okay. Just kind of splayed out on his back.
So we're doing a short rest?
That's what it looks like. Vaclo is not asking. He's telling.
Yeah, he's resting if he can. Only
unfortunately, you don't have mouse with you.
Yeah. I don't know where my hit dice are. Oh, there they are.
Front page.
I wanted to be efficient because I need 2 minutes. Be right back.
Okay. Class feature, I can regain 1 spell slot equal to half my spell, my druid level rounded up, so I will regain a level 2 spell slot.
Okay.
That's on a short rest, and then I'm going to spend some hit dice as well. Oh, maybe just one.
On second thought, maybe just one.
Alright, yeah, I'm doing fine. Hey, Goodberry was actually kind of useful.
It is. It actually is. And on top of that, you can use it to force feed someone, which almost sounds like a little bit of an intense thing since you're shoving things down their throat, but it can revive people.
Yeah, and well, I figured my main intention was to use it outside of combat, like, whoa, don't you... Here, just have some berries. Like, because I could divide it between people. Like, one spell, like, five or five. But, it was useful this time because you had bouncing the ball as a bonus action.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, you can still,
eat.
Still bouncing around.
But it was like a movie theater. I'm eating and just like looking at the fight and.
Yeah. It's like having popcorn.
Yeah.
They're minty, but they're a little bit salty too. No, that sounds like it tastes bad.
Yes, and on top of that, they're healthy. Yes. Oh, I said it. And that's when the GM usually like slams me, says a dragon comes and eats me or something.
Yeah, but unfortunately...
Yeah, I mean, your character is expendable. I could just... Yeah. The ground opens up and swallows you, taking you straight to the ninth level of hell.
Whereas, yeah, unfortunately...
Asmodeus steps on you, and that's it. Now's dead.
GG. And it was caught on livestream. CD abuse. Everybody who's watching, CD abuse I have to deal with.
No, you're not expendable for now, because...
The puns...
Because that would mess up his frames.
Yeah, I only have one fill-in frame, so I have to have you here.
Yeah, know that you have immunity.
For the next 3 hours. I'm back in the list of an important subject.
Okay.
The frame of the immunity.
So, after spending an hour resting, the entire time Gareth has been leaning up against this fallen pillar and looking around.
I'm guessing he cleaned himself up some.
Oh yeah, he took that rest. He's feeling fit and ready.
All right.
Yeah, Vaklo also takes some time to clean his armor from the mud and his clothes as well as he can.
Well, Gareth, you doing okay? It's not like you're incredibly talkative, so I'm not gonna like push you to talk. But you know, we're here for you.
He doesn't really look at you. He kind of looks over at the still water in the corner of the room, and he says, "Mm-hmm. Thanks, I guess."
I want to minor illusion some little birds flying around his head, kind of cartoon style.
And since he's so taken by the water, I'm gonna investigate, see if there's something that caught his attention.
Sure.
Perception or investigation?
Let's do perception.
That doesn't change a thing. That's my other character. Right.
You're confident it's water, but could be something else. Not so confident, I guess.
I'm gonna attack it.
That ought to teach it.
Look, the mud was a monster.
Yeah, maybe let's get out of here.
I'm all for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, Gareth stands and straightens up, and he's like, after you.
Do I need to make another investigation roll right here?
Sure.
And then Al says, don't wake up another mud golem.
I'm trying not to, friends.
I also investigate, if I can.
Yeah, it's just more ruins. At this point.
Okay. I'm gonna continue moving stealthily, so I'll roll that again. If y'all wanna lag a little bit.
Ooh, yeah.
I will lag.
Rather hidden. Do I have the dice rolls up? No, I do not.
Oh, that was 20, folks.
I pulled it up. I'm sort of on top of things.
That was sort a 15 of. Plus 5.
Alright. Well... I see a light coming from this direction, so I'm going to head that way. Because I have dark vision, so I don't need my own torch.
Okay. You come to a T-junction. Further ahead, you can see that the ruin comes to an end. You're not sure if it... I mean, it actually looks like a built wall. On either side, it looks like there was once more tunnels, but they have since caved in. However, to your direct left, yeah, you see what appears to be some incredibly bright light, daylight, coming from your left. And you also hear the sound of water. It's not running water, but like something's moving around in water.
Yeah, no, and I can see someone there.
Baron. Bunny goat is macabre.
Ah, that's right.
Poor son is the new person. Gosh. Yeah.
Forget about that.
Bunny goat.
Welcome, macabre. Nice to see you.
Thanks for joining us, macabre.
You're welcome. You needed it.
I'm still a bit woozy from getting downed, KO'd.
All right. Can I tell who's in the water? Because I can see them in my map.
Yeah, you see a rather angular-faced woman who has ocean blue skin and silver hair.
So she doesn't look like a person.
Wow. Racially profiling.
Well, a human.
She is also completely declothed.
Okay.
With her hair strategically draped over her shoulders.
Yeah, classic. Can
Yay, thanks, Simon.
This ain't any kind of fae that I'd be familiar with?
That's an interesting question. Why don't you roll... Would that be Arcana?
Well,
because,
like, I... Hmm?
Would that be Arcana to identify Fae? Let's call it Nature. Roll Nature.
All right. Just because I have it as a language, but I don't know if I would recognize. Well, that was a terrible roll.
Yeah, we're all not very thrilled about that. You have no idea what it is.
Oh, man. Does my stealth roll carry over? Can I try to get a closer look?
Look at her, trying to get a closer look to naked woman.
Yes. Look, it's Pride Month.
I mean, what are you going to do, right? You see that she's dipping her arms, her hands, in and out of the pool, and when she does, her everything that enters the water becomes the water. And you realize that everything from just above her navel is water. Like, either she's invisible, because the water's quite clear, but basically from the navel up, exists, and everything else turns into water. And as she's doing this stuff, kind of like scooping up water with her hands, the entire pool is kind of like moving, not around her, but like the entire pool is making motions as she does, and she seems quite content, and she's quietly humming to herself.
All right.
Hey everybody, welcome. We're playing some D&D.
Would that closer look help me identify her?
Wow.
I'm being real obnoxious.
Go ahead and roll Arcana this time.
All right. I'm proficient in nature, but that's fine.
I already let you do the nature check.
I know.
Oh! Same result.
All right. Well, I'm going to try in Sylvan, because she looks very Sylvan. Just something along... Well, no, wait. I'm going to take a second. Is anyone in the hallway?
Zachlu moved 10 feet since you began.
All right. Yeah, I'm going to gesture to get closer, but to stop so no one sees you.
Okay, so I'm going to stop right there.
Gareth seems impatient. He says, are we moving anytime soon, or are we just going to...
Well, yeah, I'm asking Vaclo to get closer. Just
yeah, Vaclo's
going
to, like, whisper to him, like, she's asking us to be quiet.
Oh, good.
Because Gareth can definitely move forward.
Yeah, he could.
Alright.
Nell's trying.
Well, really, really rooting for you now. Alright.
Yeah, and but I wanna say in like Sylvan something along the lines of like, I mean you no harm.
The blue woman kind of stops what she's doing and turns very, very, very kind of graciously and fluidically towards you, and she kind of smiles and she says, "Oh, a gnome."
Does she say it in East
Sylvan.
Man?
She says it in Sylvan.
Oh, nice. Okay, I'm gonna say, "Howdy." I'm really sorry. I didn't mean to intrude on any private moment. I'm just want. Do you know where I am? I'm kind of lost in here, and there have been lots of dangerous things. This is my pig friend, Askew.
Askew kind of oinks a greeting. And she smiles, and she says, "Well, if you've encountered dangers, then you're welcome to stay in my small glade." And when she says that, she like waves her hand, and on the cobblestone, between the cobblestone, all this kind of flowers start to sprout, and it turns very verdant.
Oh, you're lovely. My name's Caddy. Caddy Wampus is kind of the short version. I give non gnomes the full versions, a couple names longer. What's your name?
She says, I don't really go by a name that I'm willing to give.
No, that's fine. I understand they've got a lot of power amongst the kinds of people who speak Sylvan. I'm sorry, I can't identify you other than, I say, magical.
I can tell you that I am a naiad, and this is my dwelling.
Oh, how lovely. I'm really not trying to stick around here very long. I was asked to look for a city, and, you know, I'm small so I can fit into tight spaces, so they're like, "Hey, let's send the gnome," and I'm not a rock gnome.
In the middle of what you're saying, she sinks into the water and disappears, and then reemerges up against the path, kind of comes back up and puts her hands on the bridge over the water. She says, "Oh, Caddy, you look injured."
A little bit, yeah. There was a big muddy guy got a little dirty in that encounter.
She scoops her hands turn into water, and when they emerge, she's holding them like a cup. She holds out and she says, "Here." And she's cupping some water from her little spring in between her hands.
Oh, I really want to believe her. Yeah, I'm going to drink some water.
Okay. You heal fully.
Oh, nice. That's one hit point. Could have used that earlier, but that's fine.
Well, and you also regain one expended hit die.
Oh, nice.
Whoa, that's good.
I'll do that while I'm thinking about it. And I'm going to ask her, like, is this... I don't want to cause any problems here for you. You're a beautiful, beautiful creature. So I'm going to try and find a different way around. Do you know of any cities near here that, like, or any ways to that city that's long been untrodden by men?
There was a community of dwarves that lived deeper in the mountain.
Mm-hmm. Do you know if this would be the way to it?
Yes, I believe this would lead into the what of their city now is above water. However, they left behind some defenses. You're not the first travelers to come through.
Oh, okay. Do you have any advice for handling those defenses? Do you mind, first of all, I'm going to be respectful of you. Do you mind if I bring people through here, or should we go another way?
Oh, no. Any friend of a gnome is a friend of mine. I do not mind. In fact, I welcome some company. It has been some time.
Well, I'd love to come back here sometime and we could chat. But I'm going to guide some people through if the city is farther this way. Do you have advice on dealing with these issues?
Not advice, unfortunately. You see, I'm not really a warrior woman.
Yeah, and you're not going to go down there if you don't need to, I wouldn't think.
No, but I do know that the Guardian is not exactly alive, but is eternal, nonetheless. Unfortunately, every traveler since the Dwarf City closed its gates that has come through, I assume, has met their peril at the hands of this Guardian, to an untimely demise.
Okay, well, I know it sounds cocky, but I really think these guys can do it. I plan on staying very far away from combatives, and then I can come visit. I think it'd be a lovely time. That being said, I am going to bring some people through. I'd love to introduce you, but you can disappear, go all water-like if you want.
No, it's quite all right.
All right, I'll be right back, okay? Just like, I'll be right back. And I'm going to go retrieve everybody.
When you round the corner, Gareth is kind of like leaning up against the wall, and he's like, so who are you talking to? Can we move on?
Does Gareth at all look injured? Does anyone still look unwell?
I think you can tell that Now has a few scratches.
Scratches,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. But Vaclo's doing all right?
Yeah, and Gareth's doing all right.
All right, I'm going to gesture Now over and be like, come meet a friend of mine.
Now being himself, I'm just going to walk over.
Gareth rolls his eyes and follows.
Gareth is fully expecting it to be another rat.
Yeah, probably.
And I'm going to explain quickly to our new blue friend.
And since you guys are all here, let me take a moment. So there's this kind of this bridge that goes over this this still, clear, clean water. You can tell that the water extends beyond the walls, because you can see where the walls kind of meet their end, and this is obviously some water. And there is a single kind of triangular cut into the stone ceiling where sunlight is shining down, and it's creating a sparkling effect on one side of the water, and it's reflecting off the water and on the walls, which are quite polished and smooth, and the whole room is very well illuminated. And like I described before, in between the spaces on the cobblestones of this bridge, a lot of verdant life has kind of sprung up, and there's some flowers of various colors. It's a very calming room.
Vaclo's gonna take like a few moments to just adjust his eyes. He got used to the low glare of the torch, and he's like surprised that such a place could exist.
I'm gonna shoot a look at Gareth, like, ha, not a rat. Just as a point. But then I'm also gonna explain to our blue friend that Now is a little scratched up and would probably appreciate some water if she would be willing to share.
She nods. Using the same motions, she dips her hands into the water and then emerges again with a hand cupped with water.
At this point, Vaclo isn't sure who Caddy is talking to, but since she's
right.
A friend, he barely sees her, so he sees like an humanoid figure, and his curiosity is like piqued.
Out of not out of distrust, because he trusts this party and she trusts her, so Now he's still gonna drink from the water. But while he does so, he's still gonna do both a nature and arcana check to try and figure out like just a little bit more about this. He's a spellcaster; it's interesting. So just
sure,
just to get some background on this. So nature and arcana,
And then he's gonna drink, fully heal, and get the hit dice back, right?
Alright, yeah. You're full heal and you get one hit die back. Your knowledge of the natural world and the denizens thereof tell you that this is a naiad, which is a water spirit, a fae creature that dwells usually in fresh water.
I rolled this survey for myself to guide my roleplay.
Sure.
And Nell's gonna say thank you to the naiad.
She kind of nods very humbly.
And just enjoy the whole scene because it's very peaceful and it's nice. It kind of reminds him of his more quiet home back where they found him originally, but in a more ruin/water type deal.
She kind of withdraws a little bit, not like out of fear or anything, just kind of like she just glides along the water effortlessly, and around her these kind of like water spouts gently kind of come up, six of them, and they kind of circle around her, and she smiles and she says, "Stay as long as you like. Enjoy this respite from the harshness of the mines and the ruins."
Man, we could have taken a long rest here.
Well, Vaclo was more reassured. Like he actually trusts the creature. He's also taken aback by her feminine beauty. But he also read stories about such creatures luring men into their doom. So he's quite ambivalent. He's not sure what to think. he likes the place. He steals glance to the creature sometimes, like he wants to look at it, but he's also unsure that if by looking at it he could get charmed or something.
So really the question is, out of character, we could take a longer rest, regain some of those spell slots. I know Nao might appreciate that. I could use it. And just RP-wise, it makes sense for us to take a second and then head on our way, but it's also not absolutely necessary.
In terms of spell slot, now it's pretty much okay. He's down one, not big deal.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Since it hasn't been a really long time, Vaclo would go warn the camp that they found a place they're gonna rest, so don't worry. Do you think that's necessary, DM? Do we have to report to base camp?
I think if you guys don't return within a day, they'll assume you're dead. But, you know, aside from that...
It hasn't been long since we left camp.
No, it's been like an hour, tops.
Yeah.
Plus.
No, actually, it's been about 2 hours because we took a short rest, yeah.
2 hours.
Yeah, so I don't think we really need to rest, but I think it's a good place to come back to in case we need to rest.
Yeah, we can push on
definitely
some more.
It looks safe.
But I am gonna thank our new friend in Sylvan and reassure her that we will return.
Oh yeah, and it does bear mentioning, the entire time she's been speaking has been in Sylvan, so perhaps only Caddy could understand her.
Since after like how much time have we spent here? 5 minutes maybe?
Yeah, about.
So Vaclo kinda considers this place to be like her domain. And since he hasn't gotten attacked or charmed, he's gonna ask Caddy to thank the lady of the
water
pool. Yes, the lady of the pool or fountain for us. And yeah, he's gonna lead the way for the next.
She smiles graciously to each of you.
Nice.
And as you guys take your leave of the room, she becomes one with the water, just kind of evaporating away.
And she had to, do that. That's got Vaclo weirded out. So I'm going to keep going safely, investigating the way. I'm going to get to that junction right here.
Just make one investigation check, and I'm going to scoot you guys along to expedite your journey.
Perfect.
Yeah, I mean, everything's pretty standard. These ruins are what you've come to expect. You guys come across some areas where the ruins kind of branch off, but dead end. And eventually, I'm going to move you all again. You guys end up in this kind of room. Where an angry dog attacks.
I'm so sorry.
It's all right.
No problem.
Toddlers, dogs. It's like a real table, you know?
Hey, it's kind of quiet tonight.
Oh, so don't... You just want to jinx it.
Yeah, I have to try. I'm usually good on that.
So you're kind of at a junction here. You can go up here and see where that path leads, although let me actually see what you can see. Oh, you can't see much. Or you can go to the right or left.
I think is there any kind of inscriptions on the wall or anything?
None that you can see.
I'm going to look at these stairs for any kind of traps, because Vaklo's gotten used to that, and he's going to try to look with his torch. Look closer.
Are you rolling? Or...
Oh, okay, sorry. Yeah, I will.
Caddy, you're super hidden.
Yeah.
And I'm super blind.
Vaklo, you're like, here be a wall.
I'm gonna tap it with my shield.
Gareth, kind of passing you, is just like, it's a wall, dude.
Okay. My eyesight hasn't adjusted yet.
To the torchlight? Sure, bud. Caddy.
We're splitting up.
Sorry, I was just looking in here, but I made an investigation.
Actually, you're good. I remember, since you have dark vision, it's all black and white, so you can't make anything out in particular.
Yeah, no, but I can see, yeah.
I'm sticking with the torch.
Guys, down this way, there's just more large rooms kind of connected. I don't know how the mercenaries got to where we were. I don't know what road they took.
I've seen the corpses earlier, just before the radiant pool with your lady friend in there. We're apparently on the right track, but there's a narrow corridor in front of me.
Well, there's also more narrow corridors and rooms other places as well.
I hate narrow corridors. I have bad memories. Maybe we can choose one of the sides. I think on the right...
Let me help you out here. Vaklo, it's a dead end.
Well,
so you can
Vaklo,
either go left or right.
The left has some big rooms, and I'm pro large spaces.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There wasn't a trap in the doorway, so that's nice.
Vaklo's gonna follow Caddy.
I grabbed you, new guy.
Yeah, thank you.
Alright, under the torchlight, you guys see this puddle of very dark, almost black, barely translucent fluid. Kind of, it looks like it's spilt out from the altar 10 feet above it. Like it's coming down from the altar and flooding the floor.
Vaklo's gonna think that's one more evil puddle. He already encountered one today.
Can we roll either nature or arcana try and figure out what that puddle is from this distance?
Nature would be pertinent. I'm not sure arcana matters.
Alright. Roll in nature.
Okay, Caddy got a 17. Caddy. This bears a resemblance to a creature you're far too fond of, or not too fond, far too familiar with, living, spending a lot of your time in the Barazab marshes. This could be either just some gross sludge residue from some other plant that has died, or it could be an ooze.
Would I know whether or not that's flammable?
An ooze?
Yeah.
Not with the 17.
Oh, come on.
Well, to be fair, most things are flammable with enough effort.
Yeah, you'd think most things were poisonable, too, but...
Well, I didn't expect to poison mud, but I tried.
Well, I'm gonna whisper, like, that is either some early petroleum or a not very pleasant ooze.
Can I come back in 500 years and drive my car?
Yes.
What's a ooze? Like, around your neck?
No, a singular ooze.
Oh,
Gareth is looking at Vaco like, what kind of ooze goes around your neck?
A noose.
Oh, a noose.
Yeah.
That was a pun.
Yeah, no, I got it, yeah.
you have to learn dad jokes, come on.
No, that was in character, as Gareth.
Okay.
As a dad, I...
Fair enough. Mm.
So I'm not overly fond of going near there, but also our Aqualine friend did tell me that the dwarves who used to live here in these cities had left a lot of defenses, and I'm guessing that the things we've been fighting are those defenses, and if that's the case, I think it would be best to go ahead and face every challenge. That being said, Vaclo should face every challenge.
Yeah, Vaclo's looking at you. He's like, yeah, I'm used to that, but it's starting to smart.
We do have a new friend.
Now he's going to put a finger to his lips like I'm doing right now and be like, so the nice lady of the lake told you there were defenses, not specifying which one, meaning traps, and we've been walking around without checking for traps.
Oh,
no,
we've been checking for traps. Yeah.
Okay.
Gareth crosses his arms and says, I've been checking for traps by walking behind Vaclo.
Vaclo's better watch for traps.
we've been rolling investigation and
okay.
Just kind of applying that across the board.
Good, then.
I'm willing for one more challenge without a whole group.
You detect no traps. However, as you're studying the room with an intense eye for scrutiny, you see the puddle shift.
And I go, all right, it's definitely the
No,
ooze.
No, you didn't see it.
Oh.
That close saw it.
The torch on. Did he freeze?
I don't know. It's hard to tell when we don't have his camera. Vaclo! I'm gonna go with he froze.
Yeah.
Gold, nice. I assume that meant you found a trap. Just not as soon as you'd have liked.
Not the way they would have liked.
Yeah. Or more importantly, the trap found you.
That's very important, actually. Key to checking for traps.
Do you guys remember that first session when we didn't have any technical difficulties?
Yeah.
What happened?
That wasn't even the first stream session.
Was our first stream riddled with problems, too? I don't remember.
Not riddled. We had a few before we started the stream, I think.
Right. Well, we've had the mic issues.
Yeah.
Which is clearly Dapper's fault. Because when he's not around, they're fine.
Well, we don't know, because Mouse had problems.
Oh, Gold. That's funny. Absolutely no traps. Wait, definitely a trap. I imagine the trap, again, the trap found you.
As long as the traps are spells, with saving throws, I'm not too worried about traps. If they're machinations, I get worried about traps.
Gotcha. So since we're waiting for Vaclo to return, I talked about this in our Discord, but this is a D&D tidbit that I'm sure everybody will enjoy. New guy, you'll know. Wait, is Vaclo back?
Yeah, sorry, I'm back.
Okay. Put a pin in that. when did we lose you?
Right after my investigation check, 18.
Okay, you don't find any traps, but you did see the puddle move ever so slightly.
So I'm gonna let the group know? I guess they already know.
Well, no, we were waiting for you to tell them.
Ah, nice.
Throw a torch on it.
Okay, so if Cattywampus says that, I'm gonna throw my torch on the puddle. I'm gonna do a...
You should light a secondary torch. You can't see in the dark.
So you light another torch?
I'm gonna hand the torch to Now, ask him to light it for me, and I'm gonna throw mine as if it was a hand axe.
Okay.
Wow. I should then have rolled.
You throw the torch, and it kind of hits the puddle and bounces off of it really quickly, scattering to the ground, and actually it tumbles quite into this small puddle you guys might be able to make out right here, which extinguishes the flames. The puddle seems unaffected.
The flame never touched the puddle. Quick, another one.
All right, well... While you guys are doing that,
waste a bunch of torches like this.
Okay, now everybody's curious about the tidbit I was talking about. It's not really like a fact about D&D. It's just a D&D story. But one of my games that's off stream, we switched DMs, so I'm no longer DM in that game, and we rolled for stats, and someone rolled an 18 and 3 17s, and then they took. And then they were like, I'm a human. So now they have a 19 and 3 18s. And, yeah. So that is the biggest horror story of letting people roll is when that happens. That's all. I'm sorry for the build-up. It's not...
I mean,
I'm flabbergasted that it happened. I'm still reeling. I'm shocked.
I thought I was lucky with 17, 17, 12, 12, 8, 8.
No, it was literally like 18, 17, 17, 17. Oh, then the other two numbers were 11 and 10, so it's like... inadvertent, accidental Mary Sue. Activate. She's a paladin, which is the most powerful class in the game, arguably.
And since there's two of them, it's going to also be assemble.
And I just want to point out that in that game I'm a kobold. I decided to try a kobold, and I rolled my highest was a 14, and my lowest was an 8. So I'm actually pretty under average. But it's good, because I'm a kobold, so that's the point. Yeah.
What's going to be your class if I can do a last parenthesis?
Let's not get too off track. He's going to be... You're a rogue. He's a rogue. Moving on.
Nice.
Kobold rogue. All right. So, you want to light another torch?
Yeah, I mean, Now is gonna light one. I'm gonna light another one also.
Okay. You're gonna try to throw it at the puddle again?
Again.
I just don't really have the tools to make a flaming arrow, so I kind of figured we just throw a torch.
Well, hang on, let me get my nerd glasses on.
Wow.
Actually, flaming arrows don't really work. Wow, that's the exact same roll. That's on stream, right? Yep. Good. All right, wow. So this time you light another torch, and this time when you throw it, it's going right for the puddle, and then the puddle rises around, creating a kind of like a funnel around the torch, and comes lunging towards you.
Like a sandy gas.
I knew it.
Like a what?
It's a Pokemon, never mind.
Oh. I mean, I'm real old school when it comes to Pokemon.
Or muck. It's more like muck.
Okay, I know muck. I know the first 151.
Sandy Gash just has a hole in the middle of it that you could see through, so that's why I thought of, like...
Sure.
No,
Roll initiative.
Oh, yay, another one of these.
Look, fact, I only have so many tokens, okay?
We love slimy things.
Cool.
No, we don't.
I take it all back. Ooh. Oh, but it has minus three dex. So... Gareth is first. Gareth is going to spend his cunning action to try to hide up against the wall. He's hidden.
Nobody sees him.
And then once he is obscured, he's going to step out and take a shot from the security of the shadows. Using the long shadow cast by now to further obscure him. So he's going to fire with advantage. Our boy!
Yeah. How crazy are our rolls? Quite. Look at that. That's ridiculous.
Okay. So that is a number. 16 damage.
He crit failed and crit success.
Yeah.
Twice. Three times.
And then Gareth immediately hugs the wall again. In fact, Gareth's actually going to end up in the hallway. Now, you're up.
Well, I know what deals damage to these things, so I'm going to cast Flaming Sphere without wasting any time. I'm going to cast it on the opposite side of... Actually, it's probably going to move up, so I'm going to cast it here. And I'm going to make it bounce in him. That is the smirt. God damn it! Can I stop rolling so low?
I mean, you hit it.
I know. But I still cast so low. Anyway.
And yes, it is hurt by fire.
And I'm gonna go into the back of the room.
Okay.
Because it's probably gonna come after me.
It oozes on up. And it is gonna pseudopod all over Vaclo.
Ugh.
Plus five to hit, 13 or up, is miss. You jump back to avoid it from just plopping onto you.
Yeah, I'm still lucky.
Oh my god, Jake.
And it ends its turn next to the fire, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So it takes more of that.
You know, you should have been doing that to the mud creature.
Yeah, we should have killed it much faster. Oops.
You're bad. Yeah, so that's another five damage. Really sticking it to it. Caddy.
Yeah, I'm going to remove the description next time I roll it, just for the sake of
that. That would be ideal, yeah. Are we on the map, viewers? Yes. Caddy, it's your turn.
Did I articulate that?
I'm sorry.
No, I didn't hear you, so I was just waiting because I didn't hear him say if he'd finished. That's my bad. I'm going to try and shoot it because I promised the nice lake lady that I would stay away from combat.
Principles.
You've never made a promise to Vaclo?
Oh, yeah, this thing's really easy to hit. So you hit.
Nice. Ah, love that. Yeah, cool. 10 damage.
We're all really proud of you. Vaclo, you're up.
Vaclo's gonna be spurred on by the fact that we actually seem to be efficient this time. He's gonna attack.
You jinxed it.
I had to. I'm gonna use my bonus action to knock it off its ass if I can.
Now, hold on. Surely...
It's an ooze.
Surely an ooze cannot be knocked prone.
Oh, that's an ooze. Sorry.
It is immune to being prone, so nothing happens.
Okay.
I need
so
to go...
So that's gonna be my turn.
Now I'm just really curious. The mud creature... Was it actually... Did I screw up, and was it actually immune to being knocked prone? I mean, I'm not gonna rescind it, obviously, but I have to know.
I'm not sure. I'm not even sure what it was. Was it an elemental?
No, it was not immune to prone. Okay. Gareth's turn again. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've gone full circle. All right, he's gonna attempt to hide. Okay, yeah, he hides. This thing's got a really horrible passive perception. And he's gonna jump out and shoot. Right. That would be here. Is hit. Is 10 damage. Alright, the ooze is now injured. So now it's got like two arrows sticking out of it. A part of it's kind of on fire. Now you're up.
Poison, since it's not mud.
Oh, thank you, chat. I needed that.
So one, two, is that... Nope, I still need
one. Getting really
more.
Robotic. Is that on my end?
I can hear it too.
Okay.
I seem to be lagging out. I'm sorry for that.
That's okay. For those of you watching this on YouTube, one of our viewers, Diana, said, "Everyone knows ooze is just an ass all the way down."
She's a very good friend of mine and says things like that a lot.
Well, I'm glad. I, for one, am glad that she... so that's the flaming ooze. That's 8 damage. And then the
she
poison
has to
spray.
Beat that for our next games, then.
Is a con save, which he's going to fail. Is he good on poison? No. You can't actually poison an ooze. Who knew? For 11 damage. Whoa, 11 damage on a cantrip? That's a d12 cantrip?
Nice.
Good lord. I did not know that. Yeah, okay, so the ooze is effed up.
Nice.
And the other advantage is that it's not a concentration spell, so you can do both.
We're actually kicking ass all the way down.
Nice.
Why have you forsaken me? Alright, the ooze is going to try to eat Vaclo, mostly because of that comet. Ah, dang it. Alright, Caddy.
Protected by the gods.
Protected by the dad joke. The god of dad jokes.
Nice.
Alright. I'm going to shoot another arrow because that worked last time.
Yeah, the dad joke god takes the form of a punny. That's a hit.
I'm so disappointed.
Oh, real quick. It ended its turn.
Oh. There we go.
Yep. Yeah. I need to roll the damage. Am I still robotic?
No, you're good. I think it actually succeeded. Yeah. So it takes half damage?
Yeah.
Okay. You done, Caddy?
Yeah, that's all I'm doing. Wait, am I noticing anything happening when I shoot it? Like,
oh, yeah, yeah. It's like... It's got all these arrows sticking out of it, and it's kind of like... right now, it's kind of like vibrating haphazardly.
Okay, so my arrows aren't, like, disappearing.
Well, they might be sinking. Like, you thwum, yeah. And then they start sinking down.
Okay. I'm just hoping I can get some of them back.
Actually, I'm going to go with no. All the arrows you're firing into a ooze are probably forfeit.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
Vaclo.
So that's going to be a DM rulings question. Could I use Commander Strike to ask now to actually use this flaming sphere once more?
I believe it says to make a weapon attack, right?
Yeah.
Then you got to stick to the weapon attack.
Okay, so I'm gonna attack it myself with my torch instead of my warhammer. I'm gonna roll the same as a warhammer except for the damage.
Yeah, damage will be d4.
Plus my strength or not?
Doesn't matter. 6 will kill it. Oh no, it would be plus your strength. You've plus 5. Oh, that's right. You're a duelist. Okay, that is a dead ooze. In fact, I'm not even going to leave it on the map. It just kind of, like, explodes into a spray of gross black oozeness. Is there.
But not my arrows.
Rip arrows.
I'm going to clean myself off, because I obviously...
Did he hit? Oh, yeah. Didn't hit anybody. Myself. Sure.
Oh, good.
It exploded in my face.
That's not the first time you said that, huh?
Actually, might be. I'm going to take a couple of steps inside the room and look around.
Okay. Do you dismiss your flaming sphere?
Well, it sticks for a minute, so might as well make it follow or something away, like, safe from people, in case we meet something in the next minute.
Okay.
Yeah, or illuminate the walls while we investigate.
But leave it here, Jaken, and if it's not been a minute, you can bring it over, but if it's not been, if it's been past a minute, just dissolve it.
Sure.
I want to check out, is this an altar that I'm standing behind?
It's got the shape of an altar.
I'm going to investigate
it's so
that
old.
Boy.
I mean, yeah, go ahead and make an investigation check, but it's rather old and faded and cracked and... It's made of
nope.
Stone, you think. Backlow, on the other hand, is confident. This is stone.
Yeah, I confirm.
Oh, I need them rolls. She got a 2.
No, I got a 1 without bonus.
And we either all get over 20 or we all get under 10.
Yeah.
There's no middle ground.
I'm strangely okay with it.
It makes for an interesting experience.
You're even worse than us. It's either 95% under 10 or crits.
Okay. What next?
Since we haven't found anything interesting...
I'm going to point and say, I see a big doorway this direction.
Okay, roll investigation.
Me?
Yep.
Again?
Yep.
Okay.
Can I too?
Yeah, you both can. All right. The two of you kind of explore that area, Vaclo and Caddy, and you see that it is parts of the ruin that have any exits thereof have caved in, and you determine after thorough analysis that... there's not much to this room, and you exit.
It's
a dead end.
It's all dead ends.
Yep.
All right, that's good to know. I'm guessing Gareth is getting more and more impatient.
Yeah.
So, shall we proceed?
Actually, when you return, marking Gareth's impatience, he says, "Why am I here again? This is there's no coin."
You've signed up for this. Have you no honor?
Well,
honor is not
okay.
Really my forte.
Yeah, that's not a really good question for Gareth. I would like to remind Gareth that there is a lot of coin once we find the path to it. So that should incentivize finding the path. Well,
honestly, boredom. I charge more for being bored than being entertained.
Well, that's obvious. You pay for entertainment usually, so I don't.
Mako's gonna chuckle. He's gonna actually kind of chuckle.
But how about you start scooting those boots so we can entertain ourselves some? Huh? Yeah.
I'm waiting for my trap detector, and then he kind of motions to Vaclo.
Well, I'm.
he shuts up because he's very.
And the lizard, being the wise lizard that he is, turns to Garrett and says, "What would be the most defining trait of a dwarf?"
Boring? Short? Take your pick.
I would have went with greedy, wouldn't you say?
I haven't met many.
Well, the legends. Well, if it falls on deaf ears, no point in going through this.
All right, well, guys, there's no traps this way if you wanted to join me.
I need my torch. Vaclo.
Oh, right. Yeah, you can't see.
Vaclo.
Sorry, I've gotten distracted in the last minute. I missed parts of what's happening.
I don't like being this far away from everybody. Come on!
I'm blind if Ackle does not move forward.
Yeah, okay.
So you could bring your flaming sphere.
This is a 10-foot ledge up the staircase, this short flight of stairs. And there's this very large, it's more tall than it is wide, boulder that sort of ends in a point. And it is inscribed with dwarven runes.
Hey, we have someone who reads dwarven.
Yep, I'm just going to say now, you still have one of my torches. And I'm going to try to read the runes.
All right, you gave me one. Didn't give me the light.
Oh, okay, I'm going to...
Oh, my beard. Let me do that. Fortunately, I can do that very quickly. All right, you read the runes. It says, speak the password or suffer the fate of the stone.
I'm going to say the password out loud, Moose Man.
I'm going to say mine in dwarf, the noun.
Gareth says, does it say where gold is? If not, we should just go.
It says, speak the password or die, so...
Well, yeah. You know, you speak dwarvish. What's the word for password?
That's a good one. I'm gonna search my memory if I can.
And I'm gonna move away.
Wait, I have a quick question. You said it's tall and wide boulder. Is the point to the top or to the bottom?
To
like,
the top.
Is it point? Okay.
So yeah, I'm gonna wait for the others to move away. I'm gonna get my shield out and I'm gonna say password in dwarven, which probably sounds like Karakum.
Actually, the way I'm in this particular universe, dwarvish is supposed to sound very Celtic. So it'll probably be a lot of vowels.
Siriankaredena.
See ya, Bo Banana.
you sound like Bo-Banana. A minion.
Alright. After you say that, pieces of the stone move.
Oh no.
To reveal two kind of very circular sockets. And then all across the stone you see these cracks. And the cracks start to shift and two arms come out of the stone in very, like, jittery movement. Almost like you're playing a game with really low frame rate. And then it starts to... The entire rock starts to unfold into a humanoid shape. And it comes to rise.
Vaklo's first reflex would still be to, like, take a step back.
Oh no.
And when it comes to rise, another rock rises and blocks the southern entrance. Or exit, I should say.
We really should have just left.
And this now stone humanoid, which has the dimensions of a dwarf, however massive, says in dwarvish, intruders.
It says we're intruders.
And then you roll initiative.
No.
Vaklo's gonna say, I think I've learned my lesson with the elves.
You know, in hindsight, we probably should have just asked our archaeologist if there was any sort of password mentioned. Instead of making a pun. Just...
Vaklo's gonna, like, look at Caddy and say, we should flee. We should run. Right now is not the time.
Okay, Caddy. You're up.
Nice. I'm starting us off with a bang. Yeah, cool. I'm going to shoot it. We all know how this goes.
Yeah, try to delay it.
It's made of rock, though, so... Not not that hopeful.
Alright, your arrow bounces off at it.
Cool. I'm gonna be like, good luck!
Yeah, Vaklos already warned the group that he's not gonna tank this one. We leave up there. He's gonna point to the corridor where we came from.
Alright, and as you do that, the stone golem glances over to where you pointed. And then puts one foot down onto the ground floor with one foot kind of crooked on the ledge. And
I'm sure Gareth enjoys that.
It opens its mouth and dust billows out of it and quickly consumes it, creating an aura around it. Gareth and Vaklo, you need to make wisdom saving throws against this magic.
Ow. Give me 3 seconds to do a quick prayer. Oops. I really have to jinx it, you know.
I think I've seen zeros before, but
okay. Very rare. On a failed save, which both of you failed, you guys cannot use your reactions, your speed is halved, and you can't make more than one attack on your turn.
Okay.
In addition, the target can take either an action or a bonus action on its turn, not both.
Okay.
This effect lasts for 1 minute. You can repeat your save at the end of each of your turns.
Vaklo is gonna say with slurred speech, "We have to flee from here."
Well, it's your turn, Vaklo.
I'm actually gonna move half my speed, as you said. Okay, I can move all my speed and just take one action, though.
No, your speed is halved. Action.
Okay, it's halved. So I'm gonna use disengaged to run 15 more feet.
Disengage doesn't let you move.
Oh, shit. Okay, so I'm gonna start over.
Okay.
I'm gonna move 15 feet. And I'm gonna try to shield bash this thing on its ass.
Can you shield bash? Well, are you just doing a shove action, basically?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay. I'm not using shield master.
Right. Okay. It has a +6.
By one, once again. It's destiny, so...
Yeah, you knock this giant thing on its ass. As you're running by it,
already,
with your shield, you just slam into its leg and take the leg out from under it, and it goes and smashes into the ledge, and the ledge cracks and shatters, and rubble falls down its back.
So I can't move any further from there.
Correct.
Right?
You're
I'm done with my turn.
Gareth's turn. Gareth is really taking your advice to run to heart. He's going to spend his main action to disengage. Actually, he's going to use... It doesn't matter which one he uses. He can use bonus, because he can only do bonus or main. Then he's going to go... Whoop, 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 whoop. Oh, and this extends you. He gets to make another wisdom save at the end of his turn, so... He... Oh, shit.
Did you say I could do the same?
Yeah, at the end of each of your turn. He failed. And you
I
failed.
Also.
Okay. All right, now you're up.
Okay, so we're technically running away.
Yep.
And it seems that we are trying to run away this direction somehow.
That seems to be the plan.
Well, that doesn't look good for me, because I have to cross through the whole place.
You can cross through me, but you have to use your action to disengage to be safe.
Wait,
unless a spider climb all the way to the ceiling.
It is a pretty high ceiling.
Well, as long as I'm away from it, I can climb on the wall and then like look at it and go like yeah, no.
That's trolling in lizard.
You trying to see what it smells like?
Nice.
Okay, well, I don't have any spells that could help me with, so I guess that's what I'm gonna do since we're running away. So that's my speed again, it's 30, I believe, so 6 squares, yes it is. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, action to disengage, 4, 5, 6.
Okay.
And do I have anything that could be on bonus action? No, okay, we're good to go.
Alright, I just realized what time it is, and so I shouldn't have started this combat. So we're going to pump the brakes.
We're back at the top of the order.
Yeah, we're back at the top of the order, so we're going to pump the brakes, and we're going to take our break. Sorry, guys, I should have done this before we initiated combat. I'd lost track of time.
And before you do that, have bonus action Shillelagh just in case.
Okay. So yeah, we are going to go to break. We'll try to be back around 5:30, but probably not, probably a little later. So stick around, everybody. We got another, well, at this point, we got another hour and a half after the break of Dire Roll, Fire, and Blade. We'll see how this goes with this year Manster. Probably not too great. Let's be real.
See you all later.
See you in a bit.
Alright, everybody, we're back. I actually made it on time, but then my players were late. So
yeah, accuse your players all the time.
I'm mostly a new guy. It was actually entirely new guy. So we can...
Wow!
We can blame.
I'm never subbing for you ever again.
You joke. You love it.
You've made an enemy.
You've made an enemy this day. Yeah, alright. So, we're back. You guys are in the middle of combat with a stone golem. So
yes.
Let's flip over to that. And it's top of the round, so Caddy, you're up.
I mean, everyone's trying to...
Golem.
Yeah, everyone's trying to leave. They're trying to hoof it.
Yeah, it is a mad dash to get the heck out of Dodge.
Yeah, I'm just a little concerned. I'm on askew, so does that mean my speed is 40?
Is his speed 40?
Yeah.
Then yes.
Oh. I thought his speed was 30. But
well, I just
40.
Asked you.
Well, it says 40 on the sheet, and you made the sheet.
But yeah, there was...
I mean, I'm not going to argue it myself. Not that that hasn't happened in the past.
Yeah. I'm just clarifying.
You dared of that.
Boar. 40 feet.
Nice. Alright, then I'm able to move 40 feet because I can only move 25 on my own two little legs.
That's wrong, Jake.
A
boar only has 4 feet.
Wait, high five, B.
I think, wow, that was really good. I think we're going to have to call this session just the dad jokes.
Right now.
The dad jokening.
Not the stream of truth.
Hey, Johnny Vegas Plays, you wanna shout out yourself since you're my moderator as well?
cool. So, I'm going to... I guess we're just trying to get the heck out of Dodge. That said, let's get the heck out of Dodge. That was... How many feet was that I already did?
You can't go 2 squares in front of now.
Oh, okay, then let's get right here.
Did you disengage?
Yes, I assumed that's what we were doing.
Okay,
like,
so you're huffing it.
Yeah. That was really good. I can't even be mad. Good job.
I'm laughing. I just don't want to interrupt.
It was good. From here, just to be obtuse, I'm going to shoot an arrow. Because I can.
Wait. I thought you disengaged.
Oh, that's right. I can't. Never mind.
Yep.
Well, it doesn't matter.
No, it
you
matters.
You shot an arrow, but from your heart.
I disengaged, but then I am back here, and I could... No, I'm good.
I want that action back, real quick.
No.
Alright, the stone golem's turno. It's going to stand. Then, it is going to see if it recharges its slow breath. It doesn't. It doesn't need to. And it's going to slam and welcome to the jam, Vaclo. It has a plus 10 to hit. 8 or higher will be a hit. That's a hit. For 26 bludgeoning damage.
How? So,
also, in the chat, right. you can also thank Zolbot with exclamation thank you. He doesn't take well to constructive input, though.
I tried. I paid the price.
Yeah, so Vaclo, how is it that every single time you're not on the grid?
What do you mean, not on the grid?
You are slightly off the grid. Do you move by holding Alt? No, he froze. Now we'll never know. We tried to get him back on webcam, and the vengeful webcam deity took us out.
I mean, he's a software engineer, not a hardware engineer, so that'll do it.
And I can't be mad. I'm eating sweet potato fry. You can't be mad while eating sweet potato fry.
I've heard that. Yeah.
That's fair.
You can't even be below content when eating sweet potato fries. You know what sucks is it's Vaclo's turn because the stone golem.
Yeah.
Stone golem's done.
Well,
and honestly, the rest of you are kind of scot-free, so it kind of comes down to Vaclo.
Yeah, he needs to be able to make that will save, but the problem is that he didn't make it last time, and he can only make the will save at the end of his turn.
I think the other problem, too, is that he has the will of a potato.
It's wisdom. And he has slightly worse... No, I think he's got the same wisdom as our ranger. 8? Or do you have a 9? I don't want to undersell you. Your wisdom score?
Yeah, my wisdom's 9. But it's not the worst one.
No. But you are a ranger, so that makes it extra bad.
I mean, so far I haven't really had to use wisdom all that much.
And that is why she took Goodberry and not Cure Wounds. Ah! You lost him.
I took Goodberry because someone else has Cure Wounds and uses it.
Hang on.
And also...
Cat? Oh, no, he's back.
All right.
The timing on those crashes is...
Fun?
Heartless.
Okay, it is your turn, Vaclo.
Okay, so I'm going to try to flee. I'm going to find my token back on the map. Ooh. So the second hit... Never succeeded. I'm still alive.
There was no second hit. Oh, there is a second hit. You fucked up. You should have let it slide.
Yeah.
Oh, you dodged though.
I felt like it was time. Honest.
It was time. You wanted your character to have some hardware issues.
God. I can only move 5 feet. Thank you, guys.
15. You move 15. You get half your speed.
Because
you're being blocked.
I've been blocked.
You can get...
So I'm going to disengage, move 10, and I'm going to squeal. I'm going to whimper. Yeah. And that's about the end of my turn. That's the only actions I can take.
See, you're off the grid.
I hope I have. Yeah, what did you mean by that, off the grid?
All right. Hang on, let's take a moment out of our role-playing experience.
I do need to know that, sorry, watchers.
That's the grid, right? You see how your token isn't sitting square in the middle of the grid?
Ah.
How you doing that?
I just drag and drop.
Really?
With the select move tool.
Do you somehow have Snap to Grid turned off?
Up. Might be the case. Snap to Grid. That doesn't seem to be an option I have.
Everyone else is normal.
That's true, though. My other group is all... It's the same for everybody. We laugh about it. Sometimes people are, like, between two squares. But,
that's so weird, because, like, everyone else snaps to grid but you. What? Could be that the token...
Now that I know, I'm gonna look into that, and next game... That's
no, when I move it, it's still centered. It's just when he moves it.
It does snap right now. That's when I... Okay, so when I hold push to talk...
What's your push to talk key?
Alt. It's the alt key.
Alt takes you off of snap to grid. That's what
nice.
It is.
Okay, I'm gonna change it.
No, it's fine.
Good to know.
Now we know.
That's good to know.
All right. Gareth is going to... 1, 2, 3, and then he's going to dash. 1, 2, 3. You don't need to tell him twice to run. Oh, and you need to make a wisdom save, and he needs to make a wisdom save.
Oh, right.
Yep, he's still screwed. Okay. Now...
That's when I want to flee. I can't roll right now.
Well, I don't want to go too far, so I'm just going to spend, like, here, and I'm going to keep an eye. By the way, my flame is gone. I still see it here, but can delete.
Oh.
And, yeah, I'm going to wait for Vaco in case he gets stuck in a corner and beaten.
All right, Caddy, you're up.
Don't really want to leave Vaco
behind.
Honestly,
let's expedite this. The Golem is not going to give chase.
Yeah.
So you guys, let's just move everybody into this room. End combat here.
I was convinced that was Vaclo's time.
No, this it has very specific protocols in place, so...
Vaclo's actually one of my luckiest characters on this front. He doesn't die.
Alright, you guys all return, and let's say the minute wears off, and that effect wears off.
Vaclo's gonna take Cattywampus on her previous comment about maybe Baldrim knows the password. Maybe we should report. Seems like a good time.
Okay.
Since he's bleeding out.
You guys return to base camp. Unimpeded. And Boldum perks up when you arrive, and he's like, "Oh, there you are! How's it going in the mines?"
We found the Guardian, Vaclo says, and then Jake just like falls out on his ass on his cot.
You fall on your ooze.
Oh yeah.
And he's like,
I have to
Guardian?
PG-13.
What Guardian? He pulls out his journal. I don't remember nothing about a Guardian.
I sure did hope you would. I hoped you would know about the Guardian, and he looks like surprised at Baldrin.
I'm dreadfully sorry. I'm glad you all made it back all right. What kind of Guardian?
You've got the foremost knowledge on all of this place, which is apparently of some political and historical significance, and you didn't think, maybe these dwarves got some magic business that they're going to protect this with. That's what you're telling me.
Well, magical entities guarding doorways is, that's old legends. That's myths and fairy tales. It's not like magical guardians back in Orzhkarad. We just got doors and guards, the fleshy bits kind.
Fleshy bits don't pummel Vaclo, except for that one elf guy. But I'm going to call BS on the elf guy.
Well, Vaclo's actually going to be like,
I never led credence to those legends I read in books, but I have to admit they are very convincing when you actually read them.
And so what you're telling me is, if hypothetically it said, we're looking for a password, you wouldn't know what the password is.
I'm afraid not.
You don't even have, like, an educated guess, considering you've are the educated one here?
I tell you, I know the folklore around dwarven pass-protected, you know, passageways, but again, it's all legends. Again, in Orzhkarad, we don't got anything magical of the sort.
What, so you're not educated on the legends of your people?
Oh, sure, but according to the legends, the passwords are very specific. It's not like there's like a skeleton key of dwarven passwords.
I know, but I'm saying you don't have any guess about Orzhkarad, which you are the leading scholar on.
Well, it might be, and he says...
Rathbos actually gonna interrupt.
Okay.
And he's gonna ask Baldrim if he has any references or clear references or books on the subjects, because Vaklo would actually take some time to try.
I didn't carry my entire library with me. I don't got anything on the magical incantations, just what's up here, lad.
Don't you have your most relevant books or references?
All about the Wet City, but none of them reference any kind of magical guardian. Have you tried? And then he says, admin, in Dwarvish.
Admin?
Adamant?
No, admin.
No, admin.
I'm not familiar enough with your culture to guess.
No, we only tried password.
Yeah, and you can see where my last guest brought me.
Well,
yeah.
Do you think maybe the combined effort of your party plus the mercenaries might do the trick against this creature?
I would bet unwisely being able to help
you
us.
You mean Mouse?
How has she been? Ah, Mouse. I'm sorry. I always mix the two up. Yeah. If Mouse was up, maybe she could help us. How is she?
She's on the mend, I believe. Still bedridden.
Speaking of which, I'll go check on her.
I was about to say that, but the doctor has priority.
Yeah, you look her over, and sparing any other family emergencies, you think she'll be good to go soon.
Has she made any moves on their whatever chessboard?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, I'm gonna go make my next move.
Okay.
Wow, Vakla's making moves on our bard.
GG.
You know it?
What?
And wisely never returned. Oh, darn.
Oh no. Alright. Well, we're not getting past the big dwarf lady golem thing. I doubt there's any way to the city that isn't the big dwarf lady golem thing.
We haven't explored everything, and there might be clues in there. But
yeah, but like what I'm saying is, if you're going to make a big entrance way to secret underground city, you're going to put your big bad in front of it. And this is our biggest, literally, thing.
Carl approaches. He's like, well, it seems to me that maybe the eight of us can take it. This lizard's all right in a fight.
I was starting to think our whole group would be required.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't think Boldum and Gollum will help too much in a fight. It might get in the way. No offense, sir.
Really help.
He simply nods, as if meaning, I know what you know what I meant by whole group.
All right. Well, Wise lizard, I hate to volunteer you for such an endeavor, but I assume you're in it for the long haul at this point.
It looks like I'm sticking around, definitely.
Alright. Let's sleep on it, and in the morning, we'll go test our mettle against this guardian. And we'll try admin before.
I'm gonna take my bedroll and sleep in the nice sunny grove instead of the damp camp.
Vakta was actually thinking about trying password again.
Yeah, you know.
Maybe he said it wrong.
Yeah, wrong inflection.
Yeah. It's like Chinese.
Instead of password, you actually said pass gas. That's why it attacked.
That's why it did the breath thing.
Or as you say in French, pont de sang.
Oh, wow. Flatulence, yeah.
Yeah. I'm taking my bedroll to Naiad's Grove because it's prettier than here.
A little more damp.
I'm from a swamp.
Be safe.
I think Johnny's asking if you guys have the plague. I don't speak French.
No. He's saying something that doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but he's saying yes, hello to the beach.
I'm going to reconnect just to... I'm unable to read the chat, but yeah. I trust new guy on his French.
Oh, like, is that because I'm going to the...
No, I'm pretty sure it's like when I say, you know, like, donde está la biblioteca? It's just the things he learned.
Yeah.
Even though they're not useful at all. Especially since
all right.
Libraries don't even exist.
Okay. Why did the points go to Ravenclaw? They go to me. I speak French.
You're saying you're not Ravenclaw?
No, I'm obviously a full puff. I weigh like 250 pounds. I'm the softest guy around.
I'm a Hufflepuff too, hey!
I'm a pushover.
Yeah. No, I've caught on to when Jaqen does that.
Does what? Hang on.
String random Spanish words together. As if they're Spanish.
Sure. It's the only way to speak Texican.
Anyway, I'm guessing that's a long rest, boys.
All right, let's do a long rest. Let's get back on track.
Okay.
Bells.
Yeah, so, cheese water. It's real. Macau's face.
Oh no.
I think I'm broken.
It kind of sounds like a... Oh gosh, I don't know. I don't actually know the English word for this. Kefirs?
How do you not know the English word for something?
It's a drink I had in Eastern Europe. It's like sour cream but milkier.
Yeah, that's a noun.
As a drink? It doesn't have sounds delightful.
Translation. It's like...
I love chugging sour cream.
Well, Russians drink it that way. Most other people, like, use it to cook or mix with other things. Anyway, not the point. That would be cheese water. in my mind. And I was just like, oh, that's a terrible description.
All right, well... Now that we're all sufficiently weirded
grossed
out.
Yeah,
grossed out. The night passes uneventful. It seems that any denizens that remain in these tunnels are either keeping their distance or are unaware of you.
I highly doubt they're unaware of us. The screaming, the fighting, the spellcasting, it's
right,
probably
Vegas, that's not fair. You can't give me a foreign word and expect me to know the translation. That's not fair.
Quick question. If
quick
I
answer.
Have three total hit dice, do I get one or two on a long rest?
Two.
One?
Two.
Two?
Round up.
Thank you.
Don't help. Don't encourage him.
Well, it's a good word.
Don't
but
encourage
not,
him.
There's not a single word translation for it. I'm sorry. It was a trick question on his part.
Trying to be sneaky?
That's like a psychological
it's
thing, right?
It's like throat. It's like if I smelled something that smelled really bad and I was like, hey, smell this, and then you smelled the thing that smelled really bad and we're like, ugh, and I got enjoyment out of it, like, haha.
Oh,
of
wow.
course there's a German word for that.
Schadenfreude.
Yeah.
Alright. We learn every day.
Every moment's a learning moment.
Yep.
The only thing, I have a few German friends, and my favorite pastime is to purposely mispronounce German words. Like, when they do something nice
me
for
too.
Me, I say, donkey shit.
Alright. That said, are we heading back to
yes.
the Golem room?
So, the eight of you, the four mercenaries and the present party, head over to the entrance of the room. So you're right outside the room. You've gathered in force. So find your tokens.
Do we roll new shit?
And we have torches?
Yeah.
But I appear to still have mine.
Yeah. I was just making sure y'all could see.
So do you guys want to file into the room?
Yeah. Vato's going to try to see, like, with
NPCs
city.
First.
Oh, I was going to move everybody in, but then everybody started moving their tokens individually, and now it's all...
If you're filing in.
Vaglo's going to try to say Wet City in Dwarven with his best accent. See if that does better.
Nope.
Here we go, people.
And
brace
as it starts
yourself.
To wake up, Carl's like, say admin! Say admin!
I'm gonna say admin, but at this point...
No, obviously it's
oh.
not admin. Gosh.
Why am I close up? Why would you do that to me?
I mean, I just figured you got, you know, balls of steel.
But I don't have the AC of steel.
She had the... I'm not sure I can say that, but clitoris of steel.
Whoa! Hey now! Okay...
Hey.
I mean, you said balls.
It's not worse than bowels.
Isn't it?
No.
It sounds more scientific, but it's not. It's not more complicated.
I would like to disagree because you can play. You can have a kid play with bowels, for example, but you can't have a kid play with
balls. No,
no,
no.
Okay. You're right. 29 for Gareth. Wow. We're at both extremes right now.
Yeah, we're at extremes, alright.
We're gonna be sandwiched between Gareth and Vaclo.
Okie dokie, Gareth is first. Gareth is going to withdraw a bit and try to hide. What are you juveniles talking about in chat?
Nothing.
Yep, that beats passive. Okay, and then he's going to step forward and shoot his bow.
The problem is that Jaken cannot play scareful bleeps.
Alright. He steps forward, exposing himself once more, and fires his arrow. And, it bounces off the golem. Utterly harmless. Yuri's turn.
At this point, Vaklo might be inclined to recommend that everybody waits for him to draw the thing out. Because if we all get into the bottleneck, that's not going to be a good thing. How high are the stairs? How high is the stage?
It's 10 feet up.
So it's kind of hard to climb, right?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, maybe everybody ready themselves for when Vaklo retreats. Like, I'm gonna disengage.
Already, huh?
Well, that's what Vaklo says. Let me bring the monster to you.
Yeah, it's not quite his turn yet.
So you disengage? No, it's not your turn. It's Yuri's turn.
Yeah.
Yuri is like, what do we do? It seems impervious to our attacks.
It might be.
He dodges. Its turn. It kind of raises both fists and goes boom, boom, down on Vaklo. One after the other.
I might
hit,
die right there.
For 18 bludgeoning damage and miss.
I'm so lucky.
Caddy, you're up.
Oh no. That's awful. Let's see what we can do. I'm gonna go ahead and burn that Hunter's Mark spell. Just get that out of the way. And so it is adequately marked. And I don't want to shoot another arrow because arrows don't do anything. Stone. That's 10. It's 10 feet high, the ledge.
Yes.
I can't even attack over the ledge. Yeah, that's... Can I... Yeah, I can't do anything other than that, really. So, can I hold my action? No, I already cast the spell. All right, that's it. That's me.
Okay. Hoff's turn.
So, at this point, I'm going to specify out of character that what Vaklo is trying to organize here is a straight line of people with readied action to attack the thing as soon as it comes into range. So they have to position and be ready.
Alright, in that case, Hoff is going to hold his action. Carl is going to take a step back and ready. Oh wait, if he does that, he can't ready. No, he can ready his action.
He could, and that's the perfect move. That's the one I wanted to see.
Priska is going to hold her action. Alright, now you're up.
There's something I could do that would be pretty amazing.
Ha! Do it.
No, the problem is, it can't see. It should not see it. Hold on, I just need to double read the spell, because I'm not sure if it's still active when they don't see it.
Maybe, tell us what the spell is?
Spike Growth.
Ah, cool. Yeah, you just have to... Can you get Vaklo out of it? I'm sure not.
No, that's a problem.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing, too, is it does piercing, and I believe we already tried to attack it with something that does piercing, and it did literally, like, almost no damage.
It's gonna be a... How do we say that? Long-term fight. We're gonna whittle it down.
So, I'm gonna try my most useful spell right now. So I'm gonna do Shillelagh for a bonus action to turn my weapon to a magical weapon. And then I'm gonna cast our usual flaming sphere, and I'm gonna place it right here. And I'm gonna obviously... Oh, I can't because I cast Chalet. So it's just gonna be there. I cannot make it bounce because I used my bonus action already. So in order to damage.
That was a 10-foot wall. You cast it into...
I can cast it up in the air. So I cast it like at its level.
Ah, nice.
Where?
Here and at its level. So like right by the floor. At this floor here, so at this floor's level.
You want it here or here?
I want it here.
But it's like up high. I got it.
But it's up high, like level with this floor, so that if he stays here, he's still gonna get hurt. And if he comes here, he's still gonna get hurt. And if he comes down anywhere, he's gonna still get hurt. Right. Like, that's my plan.
He beat the save, so he takes half
no,
damage.
No. I used my bonus action to cast a letting or the damage.
I thought when you cast it, you throw it. You can throw it into somebody, or is it still a bonus action?
Let me check. Piers and I.
What Jake just said does make sense, though. I mean.
No, it's as a bonus action. You can move the spear up. So okay. I need to use my bonus action to bump into someone. All
right, Vakla, you're up.
Okay, so I'm actually gonna disengaged. And I'm gonna use second wind to try and survive for 6.
Better
That's
than
my
last
bonus.
Time.
Yeah. But I'm usually luckier on that, and that's gonna end my turn because I don't have I disengaged. Use my bonus action, my move action for... Yeah, I'm done.
Alright. Gareth puts away his bow. Realizing that it is doing nothing. He is instead... That's what I'm looking for. He's going to open his satchel and withdraw one of his leather-bound vials. It's kind of in a spherical vial. And he's going to chuck it. No! Don't have info block enabled. That doesn't help me at all.
That sucks.
Oh, Gareth, you didn't fill this out.
Do you have the information? Do you need
to... It's all right there. I just need to... It's a saving throw. It is a dex saving throw. What class is he pretending to be? Arcane trickster.
Alchemist?
Well, Alchemist isn't
among
the
right.
list. I think he's using Arcane Trickster. On a successful save, no damage. Sorry. One of my players wasn't prepared.
You're doing the best.
You're the player.
No, I'm not. Hang on. I don't remember if he had any class features that... I think he might have had a class...
At this point, don't bother.
No, he doesn't... Okay, he didn't write it down, so... I know there is one that lets his bombs do more damage, but he didn't have it. Okay, so... Cast spell. Why does it say 0? Oh, because I didn't choose a dice.
It's going to be 8 plus proficiency plus casting ability modifier.
Yeah. Which is... It's going to be... It's 13. I fixed it for next time. Okay, 13 dex save. He failed, so he takes 2 force damage.
Does force looks like it's doing damage?
Yep.
Okay, good to know.
And then Gareth's gonna go over here. Yuri's turn. He's gonna step in front of Caddy and ready in action. Its turn. Boom. Yuri's gonna pop that action. And he's going to swing with his spear. Missing. Boom. Actions are coming off. Honestly, it doesn't really matter. They wail towards the statue, and it's immune to your damage. So.
Ooh. So do we? Can Vaclo actually notice that?
Oh yeah, yeah. Immune? Just everything's bouncing off of it, just like. Like it's almost like you're hitting a statue with swords.
He's gonna shout. That's not good. We should retreat once again.
It's gonna swing at Carl. Hitting. For 17 bludgeoning damage. And then it swings its other fist at Prisca. Hitting. For 20 bludgeoning damage. Prisca is wounded.
Ow.
Ow.
Caddy, you're up.
Wait. He ended.
Oh, he did. Do that. Fire damage. Alright, he takes half damage. Caddy, you're up.
Did that do anything?
The fire, yeah.
The fire damage? Oh.
It took half.
Yeah, but at least it did some damage.
It only took half damage because of the...
Nothing is immune to magic.
Okay,
Actually...
Yeah, there's resistance or...
It has magic resistance, which I just looked at. So it actually is supposed to have advantage on saving throws.
Had to mention it.
Yeah.
It's a clue.
Do we know if slashing does anything to this guy? I'm doubting it.
I think he's immune to bludgeoning, piercing, slashing.
Nice.
All of those weapons have been used by NPCs. All of them ineffective.
Yeah, I was just making sure because you didn't specify.
Read the Twitch chat.
I can't read the Twitch chat.
Yeah.
What announcement?
I don't know. I wish.
Oh, but that's 2 weeks old. It's not It doesn't see it's from today.
I don't know. It's 2 weeks old.
Okay. I will announce later.
Alright. So, yeah, at this point, I mean, Vaclo realizes as much as Baron that if we don't flee, we're all gonna die.
Well, your two magic casters are doing damage.
Yeah, okay. So I'm gonna...
Death by 1,000 cuts.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna try, but death by one more punch is also a very real possibility.
I can't climb the stupid ledge. I really painted me into a corner here, Jaken.
I'm not a painter, you're the painter.
Yeah, which is why you didn't think to not paint people into corners.
Maybe we can go further down where it's not gonna follow us, because there's two places we haven't looked yet, and I mean, Vaclo's gonna say that.
They're dead ends. I've looked in there.
Ah!
When I came in.
Ouch.
Or wait, I don't remember if that little tunnel's a dead end.
We're not gonna take the chance at this point.
I also don't think the dwarf golem can fit in the tunnel. That's another issue.
When we get out, it doesn't actually pursue because the where we want to go is actually blocked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I can't tell if this is home free.
See.
The problem is not getting in there, is that if you get in there, I'm not sure how you'll get out.
Well, I was thinking if we got in there and it was the hidden city, no problem. But I don't think it's gonna get us free. I can't do any damage, but I'm gonna hand axe it anyway because I'm angry. I want to get to our magic users.
So the icon on the giant, that's your hunter's mark, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Do I need to roll the 1d6?
No, you didn't hit. You missed.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
You done?
Yep.
Okay. Hoff. He's going to step forward and put his shield in front of him, evading. And he says, well, let's just give the spellcasters all the time they need. Carl takes a defensive stance and says, we'll give it a shot. And Priska does the same. Now, you're up.
Fuck. Sorry about that. kids asleep, so we're good to go.
But Johnny Vegas is on, so...
Oh.
He's got delicate ears.
Burn.
I don't have infinite spells. That's the main problem. Okay, well, first let's do bonus action Flame Sphere into him. That's gonna be easy.
I mean, yeah, he fails. So he takes 7 fire damage.
Okay. How is he looking?
Hangouts. slightly singed.
Now I was gonna say, I don't think we'll have enough spell power to bring it down. Might be wiser to run. But still, until his people leave, what he's gonna do is, I can temporarily step into somebody's square and then step out, right?
Yes, but if you attack from that square, you have disadvantage.
Yeah, plus attack of opportunity. Damn right. It. Each creature in the 15-foot cube. 15-foot cube is...
3 squares.
No, it's actually 4.
No.
It's 3?
15 is 3, yeah. When you use the ruler, you gotta remember that right here is 0.
Oh yeah, the 0 is 5. Okay, so it would be this, so I would need to be... like here, yeah, here to be able to do. Oh, originating from me. Okay, so I would need to be here. Oh, well, that would be stupid.
No, you're right. From here, you'd be able to do a 15-foot cube in front of you.
Okay, so what I'm gonna do is 1, 2, 3, thunder wave in that direction, and then 1, 2, 3.
Well, hang on. That's have. A sonic burst. It's cinematic, damn it.
Nice.
He saved. He's got a +5. So he takes 3 damage. Wow. You know how there's a delay between us and them? I heard your clap through my wife's headset.
Sorry, I clap.
May have been a bit loud.
Apologize.
Alright,
And doesn't Thunder Wave, like, push it?
No, he's
only
saved.
If he, yeah. Only if he doesn't save.
Okay.
He's got 2d20?
No, it's he
advantage.
Has advantage.
Oh, okay.
Vackle, you're up.
Okay, so... give more time or try to hit in hopes it doesn't attack me. I can probably get lucky one last time, so I'm gonna try to hit it with my Warhammer. That's not gonna work. I'm gonna try to knock it down. And that's hard.
Yeah, you knocked him prone.
Okay. And that's gonna end my turn.
Alright, Gareth comes from around the corner, and you can all hear him sigh and goes, "Could you not knock it down? Makes it harder to hit." Then he's going to throw the bomb with disadvantage.
Oh no.
But it doesn't actually matter because it's a saving throw. I guess that's good. Oh, and actually it has disadvantage on dex saves. So Gareth is an asshole. But mechanically it's actually helpful. So this is disadvantage. Which he's still succeeded. So he takes no damage. He's going to go back over there. And then and as he comes back, he's like, "Actually, never mind. Keep doing that." Yuri is going to evade. Big thing's turn. It's going to put one fist, kind of slam it towards the ground at Vaclo. Just missing you. And then another one towards Caddy. Just hitting you. Slamming you in the small, fragile face for 23 bludgeoning damage. You are
Did he stand up?
He did stand up.
Okay.
Which means your hunter's mark is going to end.
Yeah, because
So he just makes Caddy into a mostly solid puddle up against that small wall.
Yep.
And Caddy, death saving throw.
Yep. So, I'm gonna blame whoever said admin.
I actually said something else.
That's a fail.
Yep, I know.
Hoff is going to continue to evade. Carl is going to stop evading and he's going to try to turn and render aid to Caddy. I don't think he's skilled in... No. He has a plus zero. Actually, you can use dex, right? Let's say you can use dex. Nine or higher. Nope. Priska is going to continue to evade. Now, you're up.
Well, first bounce the fire.
Well, he saved.
But that's how much saving damage he did. Well, okay, at least I
actually, that should you should have done that at the end of his turn, right?
Oh yeah, that too. So do it again. Rolled it again.
Oh, and with advantage. Okay, so the full 8 damage.
Okay, so he half 5 and full 8. And then I still have an action, and one of our players is having trouble, so I'm going to move up to her and cure wound.
You're at 5 hit points.
And I'm going to stick in this corner for now, because I repeat again that I don't seem to be doing all that much damage, and Garrett either. I'm not sure how long we can keep this up or how long we can last here.
Alright, Vaclo, you're up.
Vaclo's gonna agree with the Wise Lizard. He would also agree with Wise Wizards, but he's still gonna wall up into the beast or try to.
Well, you hit your Warhammer. Just kind of smacks against the stone leg.
Mm-hmm. So spurred by this fact, he's gonna try to knock it down its ass.
It resists.
Ah. Right. I'm gonna wait until next turn to use action shards.
Okay.
So I'm done.
Oof. Resounding 1 damage, which it resists. Yuri's turn. They're just going to keep evading. Alright, the Iron Golem's turn. It's going to slam down towards Vaclo, just punching towards the ground.
I was scared of that.
Hits you for 19 bludgeoning damage. Seeing that Carl has its guard down, it's going to slam towards Carl with its second fist. Hitting Carl, 4, 13 bludgeoning damage. Carl is now wounded. Caddy, you're up.
Can we not keep screaming potential passwords?
I think it's too late. She's identified us as intruders. She said so.
Yeah. Oh, man. Why are we back here? All right.
I suggest we get out of here.
Yeah, I gotta stand up first, so check that off the list. If you could remove the prone. Thank you. And then I'm gonna... I can't disengage if I stand up from prone and, like, move away.
I don't think standing up is
standing
an action.
Up, standing up is part of your move. It takes half your movement. Disengage is an action, so you can finish your movement running away.
Okay. So then I'm gonna disengage and move.
Okay.
I just this direction.
Okay.
There we go. Sorry, guys. That's my turn.
Actually, you can't get to there.
Oh, yeah, just here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Hoff's turn. He's going to move to this corner and then evade. Carl's turn. He's going to move over here and evade. And as he does, he's like, are we getting out of here or what?
That clue's going to nod. I think we are.
Alright, Priska's turn. She's going to move to here and evade. Now you're up. She ended her turn, or it ended her turn.
Yes, I need to get used to that. Like I really am not. So that's for her standing it in there, and that's for bouncing into her. Okay, so half on each. Okay, I'm gonna go. 1, 2, action, disengage, 3, 4, 5, 6, and that's the max I can go.
What the fuck?
Back low, you're up.
The fuck? Oh.
Hmm.
Okay.
Okay, so I have some choices. I'm gonna use... I already did, so I can't do that. I have to play safe. I'm gonna use disengage and talk into the same corner I did earlier.
Okay. Gareth's turn. He's gonna throw one more bomb in an uncharacteristic show of bloodlust. Not that he's rolling really well on the damage, but he did do 1 force damage to the creature. And then he's gonna screw off. Yuri's turn. He's going to disengage. Its turn. It's going to try to attack Carl. Hitting. 14. Carl is badly wounded. And then it's going to try to hit Hoff. Hitting. And Hoff is knocked unconscious. Caddy, you're up.
Cool. We've got someone knocked unconscious in there. Can't leave him. I can't go back and save him.
I'll try to drag him.
Wait. Yeah, I have nothing. Good luck. And then I'm gonna run away. Like, no, thank you.
Oh, and as for the chat, just because new guy streamed with us doesn't mean he's been in chat.
Yeah, I know. That was kind of a nudge at him not being in chat.
Ah. That's okay. One of you, it took you, like, till session two to get in there. No, to session three before you got it. I think it was Wisely, and it was like... Alright, Hoff's turn. As an NPC, he gets one roll. He either stabilizes or dies. He stabilizes.
We're lucky on this front. I think that's the second time this same guy does that.
Carl is going to move up, and he's going to use his action to throw Hoff behind him. Priska's turn. She's going to move to here and continue to evade. Now, you're up.
How's this guy looking, and what kind of armor does he have?
He's not looking good. He's badly wounded. He is wearing splint mail.
So he probably has more AC than my bark skin could give him.
A cure wounds might save his life, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm probably gonna do. So I'm gonna move 1, 2, 3, cure wounds on this guy.
Okay.
Yeah, I forgot that. I'm gonna do that as well. And then 1, 2, 3, and bonus action, bounce the sphere into him. So first roll is for him, for her standing into it, and it's the second roll is gonna be for the bounce.
I think we already did the standing into it.
Not this round.
Did we not?
No, we keep forgetting.
For its turn after Gareth.
Right. Okay. Gonna take the full damage both times.
Okay. Okay, I'm really gonna pay attention. I'm not gonna forget this.
Okay, so I'm gonna let the others, Priska and Carl, know that once they get out of the room, they are safe, and that I'm gonna take care of Hoff. So I'm gonna move there, grab Hoff between under his arms. I'm gonna drag him like. Where I can maybe hear.
Yeah, that's about as far as you can move because you get half speed while dragging somebody.
Exactly, so I can't get past now, and that's gonna end my turn.
Gareth,
I'm sorry, I'm fat.
He's gonna lean against the wall, waiting for everyone to get out of there. Yuri, just gonna step there. Gollum's turn. He's gonna do 1-1. So first on Priska. That's a hit.
Oh.
But not a crit. Priska is unconscious. Second attack against Carl. He's a hit. Carl is unconscious.
Oh. They have to stabilize or they're dead.
Yep. And they're
Taddy,
all before me, so there's nothing I can do.
Let's see, that's 10. I can't stand in the same place as someone.
Yes, you can. And if you attack, you get disadvantage.
Yeah, I don't need to attack. I can't get close enough to attack. I think I can make it to next to... Oh gosh, who is Vaclo dragging? Carl?
That's Hoff.
Hoff,
okay.
Carl is here.
He's good. He's stabilized. Hoff is
stabilized.
Stabilized?
Oh.
That's these two that we worry about.
You can get to them because you're riding your mount.
I can make the 40 feet?
Yeah.
Okay.
At 40 feet, you move 8 squares. That's crazy.
Yeah. I'm gonna fill my hand with berries.
Isn't that an action though?
Yeah, can I still move?
Sure, yeah.
I can't shove them in their mouth though, can
I? Yeah, right, that's an action. To force feed.
It's not a bonus. Force feeding? No, that's okay, I'm gonna get right here.
Maybe if Jaken gives you an acrobatic check to just like twirl it with your thumb into their mouth.
Yeah, I don't think I can, like, make them chew. And all right,
Carl's
shove it down
turn.
Their throat.
Ouch.
Prisca's turn. Prisca stabilized. Carl has died. Now you're up.
Well, now is going to move here. Check on these two quickly. Notice that Carl is dead. But he's going to grab Prisca and step in this square here and pull her like on the square he was in. So at least she's away from that room. Hopefully that thing leaves everybody alone.
Is the stabilization that
you
safe,
forgot again.
Which is dangerous.
Oh, yeah. I told you I would not forget. I forgot. I'm sorry. Oh, shit. It's saved, but oh, shit.
Still better than a 3.
And then, on your turn, you want to bump it?
Why the hell not? It killed somebody. I'm full of blood lost. No, okay, it's safe.
Still, you were more sufficient than everybody else by at least
a lot.
100%.
Backlow, you're up.
I'm gonna keep dragging off, like. Can I do that? I could. I'm gonna drag him in front of me here. I'm gonna go back for Prisca and drag her.
That's an action. Yeah.
Yeah, that's 30 feet at half and not half. And it's gonna be my turn.
Okay. Gareth watches. Yuri just looks over at Hoff.
Good night, Caddy.
I looked over
good
and
night.
I saw Caddy just like. Alright, both fists come slamming
you.
Down on the gnome.
Good night. It was fun. Oh.
That's a hit.
Oh, she's done. Oh, yeah.
There's
20 bludgeoning damage.
Thanks for all the fish.
And since the first one knocks her unconscious, the second one is going to reach over her body and punch into now.
Hey, no, that's not fair. It hits.
You take 22 bludgeoning.
That's not fair. I still stand by my...
Okay, Caddy, death saving throw.
Thanks, guys.
I can save you from more pummeling, but...
That's one fail. Right, now you're up.
Okay, so...
I need to remind you, the fire... Actually, the fire is no longer... No,
he moved.
Yeah, that's right.
She moved, so on this turn... I was actually paying attention, and the one turn I would have remembered, she moved.
Rip.
Okay, so it's an action to grab Caddy, right?
Yep.
But she's on her little piglet, no?
Yep.
Do I trust the little piglet to drag her away?
Make an animal handling check as an action and you can kind of tell Askew to run.
I feel like Askew would know.
I'll give you advantage.
Advantage as well?
Yeah.
Whew.
Okay, yeah. Askew's like...
So it will run away with her?
Yep.
Okay, I'm gonna
in
cure
fact,
wounds.
No,
her.
But it already had its turn.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's kind of why. Like, I'm surprised that Hit didn't drag her away. But I'm hoping that since she's unconscious, at least the thing will think she's unconscious. I'm hoping it leaves her alone because what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use cure wounds to make sure she doesn't die.
I have a handful of berries.
Yeah, but it will take an action to grab them from you, and then an action to make you eat them. So
oh,
I don't have
an
two actions.
To take them?
Yes, because I need to find.
They're probably on the ground, and ask you sexually eating them.
So anyway, you're back to consciousness, and I'm skedaddling out of there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and I think I'm safe here, so I'm gonna stick here.
All right, Vaclo.
Okay, I'm gonna keep dragging Prisca since I see Caddy opening her eyes. I'm gonna drag Priska as far as I can, 15 feet.
Small point. I whispered to Caddy as I healed her, don't fake that you're out.
Like, keep your eyes closed.
Yeah, like, don't move. Fake that you're out. Trust that your animal will drag you away.
And that's gonna be my turn.
Okay.
Oh, and I forgot Jake and Bonus could have bounced into that. And then the turn next to it.
Do it, it's
yeah,
not
but
gonna
you,
die,
you
but
didn't forget.
Funny.
Yeah, okay. Caddy, roll deception. Or survival.
Wait, deception is based on charm, so not that.
Survival is supposed to be replacement.
Okay.
Am I convincingly dead?
Yep.
That's past its passive perception?
Yep. Alright, so Caddy, I assume you're just going to escape. Are you going to grab Carl?
Wouldn't it notice if I grab Carl?
I'll do it.
But it's your... Yeah, okay. Let's just assume someone grabs Carl and you guys get out of
there. Yeah, I'm going to... I just wasn't sure if that would risk my deception.
Actually, let's make it a little bit funny. So, Nao knows that the guy is dead, and his instincts as a lizard folk is to go and scavenge the dead body, for obvious reasons, but he doesn't want to get pulped into, like, bust into a pulp by the big thing. So he drags the body back, and then one of the alive or conscious dudes goes like, "Thank you for bringing back Carl's body," and he goes like, "Oh, crap."
Like. All right. Combat's over.
The morale
what do you do
is
with
fairly
the,
low.
The balls, the fire, the sphere. What do you do with it?
I guess I'm just going to make it dance in front of the thing to like teach it the lessons. I'm like, "Ha, next time we'll get you," but then it just poofs.
Okay.
maybe we can like kill it by just watching you bob the sphere into it from the corridor next time.
Well, I think it will turn back into a rock as soon as we walk out, and I don't think it'll do damage into a rock.
It did walk back, but yeah, no, you can't really do much damage to it, even with a little bit of fire. Yeah, that's...
I didn't think it would work, but still, that's what Faklu would like to happen.
Let's just not talk at all in that room.
Yeah. Yeah. The
well,
at least
not in Dwarven.
Yeah.
The role is quite low, right?
So what passwords have you tried? Password, admin, and...
Wet City.
And Wet City?
We haven't tried admin yet.
No.
And if admin is the password, I'm going to be... You know the word...
All right.
I guess we go back to base camp?
Or no, we don't even have to go that far to heal up.
Oh, if you have...
There's magic water, yeah.
All right. So you guys all head to the Naiad's chamber?
Yeah.
All right. She looks worried as you guys approach, as she emerges from the water.
And then I'm going to explain in Sylvan about the golem thing and the idea of a password.
She's like, I do not speak Dwarvish, so I wouldn't know. But I can sense that one of your comrades has faded. If you would like, you can bathe him in this water, and he will be revived. But it will take all the magic of my pond. I will not be able to restore its healing properties for many moons.
Will you be okay?
It shouldn't affect me.
Okay.
Maybe I'll
That's
be a little
good.
Sleepy for a week, but...
I mean...
Does Vaklo know about the exchange?
Do you speak Sylvan? Yeah.
Would Elvish be able to pick up on some of those words?
Yeah, maybe like a different dialect. You might be able to pick
but
up on a few. Not enough to really piece together.
I especially meant as a broader term, like, after the discussion, is Caddy gonna...
Oh, well, we're not there yet.
We're oh, yeah.
Jumping
that's
ahead.
An RPG decision.
Right, right. Sorry.
Well, is there a time limit on, like, can we each maybe get a sip? I feel really bad talking about it as if this is some sort of commodity. This is your
home. Of course. She rather hastily delivers water to each of you. So you're all full health.
Ooh.
And then she says, what about now?
Well,
what about me?
Yeah, that's fine as long as it's not hurting you. Like, I was really worried losing the magic of the pond would be bad for you, but if it's not gonna hurt you, then yes, let's get him in the water. Like, I don't want to seem insensitive. It's just humans die all the time, you know? They don't got very long lives. So it's like, if it's gonna hurt you, then I wouldn't want to... But yeah, sure, let's... I'm gonna explain that to them first.
Okay.
And then I clarified all
the only books. Conscious mercenary, which I believe is Yuri, is like, well, yeah, all right, let's do it.
I'm so sad I don't speak Sylvan, because when you said that all humans die, like, often, you would have said something along the lines, yeah, they're not built as strongly as lizard folk.
Yeah, we can damage you.
Once Vaklo hears about that, he's going to ask the same kind of question Caddy asked, like, is it a sacrifice for her, or is it a danger for her? And when she explains, he's going to vow that if she revives Carl, he's going to make everything in his power to protect her for her sleep, her slumber, whatever.
Okay. So, you dip Carl and immerse him into the pond, and there's this kind of ripple that shoots out from his body, and the water kind of before it was like perfectly clean, but as you guys pull Carl out of the water and he takes in a breath, the water begins to get murky and muddy, and she kind of goes and she nods to the gnome before sinking back into her pool.
Vaklo's gonna put a hand on Caddy's shoulder and say,
that's so sad.
Well done.
And Carl's like,
saved the life.
Oh, what happened? Did we win? Why am I all wet?
I'm just gonna be like, you be grateful.
What happened?
Saved him like a year max.
Vaklo's just gonna like get him out of the water and
yeah,
say,
yeah.
He's like, come back amongst us, friend.
Did I go somewhere?
He's
no.
not gonna answer that. He's gonna give him some water from his flask to drink, and he's gonna try to brush off the subject.
I'm gonna rename him Lazarus.
I should see a drink for the pole. All the other mercenaries are awake, and yeah, they'll like put a hand on Carl, and they're all really grateful. They're like, all right, we need to get back to base camp.
Yeah.
We need to find that password. Or an army.
Come back with an army. An army to attack the person who's immune to non-magical weapons.
We could
smart.
Win with a meat grinder, like Warhammer 40k style. Soldiers until
human
the
waves.
Problem is solved.
Yeah, yeah. Just bury him in corpses. Now we can get past him. So once you're back at base camp, Carl is like, all right, well, the brute force method didn't quite work.
I know. It's surprising, isn't it?
Well, to be fair, it looked like it was completely immune to normal weaponry. And despite being a
magic user myself, I could already tell that it was going to outlive my powers and probably outlive me as well.
That is worrisome.
All right, well, it's highly unlikely we'll be able to find another way into the wet city except through it. So we need to come up with a real plan.
Yes, we need more information. The password or the nature of this guardian.
Well, go ahead.
Do you think there might be a hint to the password somewhere in this cave system, or have we, like, kind of drank it dry, as it were?
I sure hope the answer was not in the water, but it might be in some dwarven hidden scripts somewhere in the cave system.
Well, being the wise lizard that I am, I think we have three avenues that I can see. The first one is this thing most likely has a password that, if I judge by how I would do it myself, I would leave a possibility of finding that password somewhere in case I forgot it. So yes, it is possible that somewhere in the ruins we find it. Which leads to my second avenue. We're blocked anyway. Might as well explore the ruins while being careful for the other defending denizens. And the third avenue is finding a way to make our weapons magical. We could potentially get through it with magical weapon.
I'm not sure I like the idea of magic, but you do bring some arguments.
Or you can try hugging it. And I'm not sure it's going to do much.
We could try dealing with the boulder that's in the way without saying...
Jaken, out of character here, I think the boulder's not there when we don't activate the dude. It's only when we activate the dude that the boulder goes to the south door, right?
Yes.
So we can go through the south door. If we don't say anything in that room and don't activate the golem.
Yeah,
I think I'm done with trying passwords.
Well, by my calculations, we could be doing this about one infinite times.
We don't even know a character limit.
I'm actually out of character, surprised that Zaklo didn't get knocked down by this creature yet in two tries. Everybody else, but not Zaklo. That's kind of weird. But yeah, Zaklo's gonna agree with now that exploring the ruins or trying to without waking up the creature. There's also a stone which kind of blocks the south corridor when the creature appears. We don't yet know if we can't go there without waking up the guardian. And there's a couple of dead hands, but they might have clues that we missed the first time around. So there's plenty of possibilities that we haven't like checked up yet. So Vaklo's gonna, in conclusion, agree with now.
Okay. Boldum is going to pull out a book.
I thought he didn't carry his library with him.
He didn't carry his whole library with him. He's like,
he actually took some time to read after Vaklo reminded him.
Yeah. I've been going over the books I brought, and I think maybe this book might help.
Zaklo's gonna grumble, but he's gonna forget about it soon. He's gonna be curious.
And he hands it to Vaklo. He says, I brought this book, not for myself, but for the rest of you. It's a book of dwarven idioms. It's to help other people learn dwarven.
I think I remember this book.
Maybe one of these idioms is the password. But there's a lot in there.
I might as well get to it.
Oh no.
I'm actually gonna try to like read it quickly, trying to find any reference to guardians or wet cities or I was gonna say underground cities, but that's just dumb. And yeah, I'm until somebody else like asks me to go exploring, I think I'm gonna be into this book to see if I can find a clue.
Okay. Make a history check.
Oh.
Okay.
I'm actually good at history.
Quite. Yeah. You find one. That says, one of the idioms is, words produce no gems. Mm-hmm. And for some reason, it jumps out at you.
Words produce no gems. So gems might be an actual word. Do I remember seeing any reference to gems in the... No, I don't. Okay. I'm gonna tell the rest of the group about... I'm not sure, but I think this one might be interesting for us. Words produce no gems.
Well, if you're gonna try it out, I don't mind it, but what you're gonna do next... I think the best strategy would be for you to stand as far away as possible that you can to activate it while using the password, and the moment it starts activating, just run out of that room.
Yeah, and maybe
y'all, don't say anything at all through.
you cut up at the end.
Just walk through. If you, that means not having words. Produces gems, like, just go through. What do we think is behind it?
The actual objective?
You might actually be right. There is no password.
No, that doesn't sound like Edward.
Boltham is like...
We haven't checked the rest of the room.
Why don't we look in the southern chamber? I'm gonna ask Baldrin just to make sure, because... Faklu probably knows the answer to that. Do dwarves give value to gems? Are gems of value to dwarves?
Wait, where?
Aye, of course they are, dwarves.
So if words produce no gems, then words are worthless.
Except as passwords for giant stone creatures that kill people.
He's not still dead.
But I also should mention that the creature asked for the password, not the passphrase. We dwarves, we're very specific.
Yeah, you're known for being pedantic.
He's like, I don't know what that word means. I need to get my dictionary out. He's got a Eastman, you know, the Dwarvish dictionary.
Yeah, I can't really blame you for that. I mean, I understand what it's like speaking Eastman as a second language, and it is a confusing language.
Why do they make the GH sometimes sound like F?
Alright, so...
That's how evolved people talk, isn't it? He's gonna look around and find most of the words.
both Boldum and Caddy roll their eyes.
Like, I want to point out that evolved people live longer than 8 years also.
Maybe, Maybe if they lived longer, they'd fix their bloody language.
That's what I'm saying, right?
He's, if Axel's gonna go back to his cot, reading some more of the book and thinking about the phrase, because that's not gonna lead anywhere. He just says that grumbling so that the dwarf and gnomes know that.
Okay. Well, unfortunately, with this puzzle looming over the party and an incredibly dangerous foe blocking their way, we are going to have to call it a night.
Walking our way?
No,
I
blocking.
Really did hope you would.
Blocking.
Okay, I was about to be
blocking.
Like...
Why do BL sound like double E?
Damn it, Eastman. We're going to have to call it a night there. Before we sign off, one quick announcement. I don't know. I mean, we had a few people watching us on Tuesday, so but this coming Tuesday, Johnny Vegas Plays and I will be playing We Were Here 2, the sequel to We Were Here. Baron, I know you joined us on Tuesday.
Yeah, I actually enjoyed the first time very much.
The first game was only an hour long. Hopefully the second one's a little bit longer because we actually have more time. Last week, we only had the hour, so it was perfect. And we actually beat it, which surprised me because we're not great.
VR games aren't that long if you're efficient.
Right. So Johnny Vegas Plays and I will be doing that again on Tuesday. Unless I have a baby. My wife's like, unless the baby comes. Because the baby is due this week. So,
ooh, hey,
assuming
congrats and
no,
good luck with that.
Yeah, thank you. Assuming no baby, on Tuesday we'll be playing. And I don't know, Johnny Vegas, I don't know if you're still in chat, but I think we're going to try to make Tuesdays a thing between him and me. So if that becomes the case, I'll add it to my my weekly schedule. Yeah. But otherwise, this coming Tuesday, yeah, we'll be playing some more puzzle games. Should be lots of fun. Hope everybody can come and join us. And thanks to everybody who tuned in tonight. Thanks for all the raids and the hosts. It was really awesome. I don't know how much we retained. I haven't been paying too much attention to the stats. But despite it, it was a lot of fun having everybody here. I hope we put on a good show. These combat-heavy sessions, I'm always concerned, but I think we had some
fun. We're trying to make it interesting.
Yeah, we had a good time. And hopefully, not that I don't love you, new guy, but hopefully next time we play, we'll have the original cast back together after quite a long hiatus of having everyone.
Well, you keep saying that, and I keep coming back. So obviously, you're doing something wrong.
Clearly, yeah.
Still, all that being said, thanks for joining us, new guy. Always a blast.
We appreciate everything you've done to keep us alive.
Oh, and Tuesday, we will be starting at 9 p.m. Central Time, assuming I don't have a kid.
All right.
Although, honestly, even if... And if it's post-birth, I'll be available at 9 p.m. You'll be asleep. Yeah, whatever. We'll figure it out. Play by ear.
And I would like to point out that Jaken likes to have kids because he hates sleep. I'm fairly certain that's my theory.
Yeah. That's pretty much it.
I'm sure that's the only part of having children he enjoys.
Yeah, literally it's like, man, how could I stop having sleep? I got it.
Yeah,
that was the entire motivation, start to finish.
It really shows how he talks about the kid on Discord. That's all he cares about. I mean, no. Obviously loves the kids.
Yeah, I'm thinking about having a little game show where I put up something my son says and everyone has to interpret it.
Nice. Will you adopt me? I had to make it weird, you know.
I mean, is this like a green card adoption?
Yes.
Yeah. No,
I mean,
I want to send Canada.
I mean, I can't speak for Elenia, but I would adopt you, Baron.
All right.
I'm honored.
That being said, I have a quiz at 7:30 tomorrow morning, so I'm going to go.
Okay, yeah, so I won't hold anybody up. All right, so thanks for everybody. We will be back next week, probably, hopefully, and we will probably play on Tuesday. Me and Johnny Vegas Plays, probably, hopefully. Be there, 9 p.m. Tuesday, same time, Sundays. I love everybody. Mwah. Good night.
Take care.
Take care.